I don't know. Maybe.
Can you believe that our first collab is a South Park collaboration? Oh, well, I guess you've been on my channel for my birthday.
Yeah. Yeah, it was wonderful.
Why does my model look so fucking happy? I'm not supposed to look happy next to you.
Yeah. You look so... Tell me you love me.
I love you. I love you so much.
Yeah.
I love
my life. Hello, chat! Does he say hello?
Hi. What are they? Capipolis?
Just call them chat.
Capipolis.
Say fuck you, chat. No, don't be nice to them. Yeah. Be mean to them.
Chat.
Yeah.
You know who Pippa loves more than chat? Me. All me.
You should have said Jesus, because I love Jesus. I do not love harlots who don scarlet letters. Scarlet Shibari. Whore.
Say that to me again.
Okay, we're gonna do some South Park stuff. Dizzy, how long have you been watching? Shut up, Dizzy, I'm speaking. How long have you been watching South Park?
Since my first lifetime. I can't age talks right now, even though it's pretty obvious how old I am.
You're kind of a hag.
Going down South Park and I have myself time! Jumping sound is everywhere! Loneliness and degradation! Going down South Park and I take my woes with me!
What the fuck?
There's alternate intros to the South Park intro, and there's like a goth one, and it's most face connecty because it's all about death and sadness and loneliness and degradation.
Okay, that one's your favorite?
Yeah, that's my favorite. There's a Tegrity Farms one too. I don't know if you know what Tegrity Farms is. You're playing the first game, right?
Yeah, I was. Okay. Yeah, well, not right now. We're gonna look at other South Park stuff. This is the training arc, so next time I play South Park, I'll know what's going on. I'll get the jokes. Okay. Yeah.
I prepared some videos, not very many, but I prepared some videos for you to look at.
Before,
if you have any questions...
Before you do that, I found a how much do you know about South Park quiz.
Okay.
And I figure what we can do here... Is we can get like kind of like a like it's like a litmus test, you know, like how much of South Park fans we are.
And, all right.
And I'll answer them, right? And then you'll tell me the correct answer.
Got it.
Okay, I'm gonna screen share my screen. Maybe if I can find it. Oh, it's somewhere on here. Oh, this is such a pain in the ass. Okay, here we go. I found it. Okay.
Lovely.
Okay. Can you see the screen, or is it like a bunch of white bars?
It's a bunch of white bars.
Oh, that's not good.
No, it's not. I can just watch your stream on mute. But there'll be a delay.
Yeah, there'll be a delay. I don't know why it's just turning into white bars. You know what? I'm gonna screen share my entire screen, and if you see docs information, just pretend you didn't see it.
Oh my god, Pippa, I can't believe your real name is... Peppa Pipkin!
Wow, that's crazy!
That's crazy!
Oh, I should also make like a little, I should ask chat. I should ask chat if they're South Park fans. Do you guys watch South Park? Chat, the collective hive mind that is chat? Do you think they watch South Park? Do you watch... Fuck, I misspelled it. Oh well. Oh, they're all saying yes!
It doesn't matter. Yeah, there's a lot of yes.
Oh... Okay, this character...
Do you do thanking your super chats during or after stream?
It depends if they say something funny or not.
Ah...
This is a meritocracy. And also, I get distracted by the $2 ones.
I appreciate that.
This is Kyle, right?
Yep. Yeah, that's Kyle.
Kyle Baflowski.
What do you think of Kyle?
He looks kind of stupid.
He's best known for being a preachy little shit, but, you know...
Is he flamboyantly homosexual? Or is it just the pose?
Just the pose. I would say of the main characters, he's like the third most homosexual.
Oh, and who's the most homosexual?
Stan.
Stan. Which one is that? Wait, no, don't tell me. It might appear in the quiz.
Yeah, we'll find out. We'll find out.
Yeah. Oh, hey, Pippa. Oh my god, Dizzy, I got the funniest fucking joke for you. Dizzy.
Oh, okay. Hit me with it.
Okay, a man walks into a bar.
Mm-hmm.
That's it.
Yeah.
He says, he might say, ow.
Aha. Also, sorry, chat, I'm gonna fight chat on this. Chat, the creators of South Park have openly said that if any of the boys in the main group of boys were to be gay, it would be Stan because he's the most emotional. Fight me later.
That's kind of playing into homophobic stereotypes, actually.
Oh, also, shut the fuck.
Why are you reading creator interviews where they talk about the sexuality of how old are these boys? How old are they? 10?
10?
Yeah.
Well, if you know anything about my character canon, Pippa, you know that we've entered the Shotokan era of my character. Because I'm nothing if not pandering.
I don't know if that's pandering unless you're a family channel. Jesus Christ.
Get ready for Minecraft 24/7 and apparently Five Nights at Freddy's.
Hell yeah. Oh god. Okay, who is Cartman's long lost brother? Is it Kenny? Kenny McCormick?
No, it's not, but you can click that.
Oh.
Who was it? It's Scott Tenorman.
What the fuck is Scott?
You'll see him in the clips later.
Okay, who is he related to? Who is this?
That is someone's older brother.
Fuck. Is this...
Pick all the correct answers. That kind of gives it away.
Oh yeah, he's probably like a McCormick, right? That's why there's so many. Okay. I'm so fucking smart.
So fucking smart.
I'm so smart. Okay, wait, how do I go to the next question now? Oh, next. Okay, never mind. Never mind. I missed. Oh, fuck. Oh, well.
Oh, fuck. Okay.
Okay,
this person really, really likes Kyle.
He really likes Kyle?
He really likes Kyle. There's two Kyle questions in this entire this quiz so far.
He looks as Womack.
Yeah, that's the same thing, right?
Same thing as what? What's his actual religion?
Jewish?
Oops. Oops. You know, I thought about it for a moment, and then I was like, no, that'll get clipped out of context. So you know what? If anything, alright, I knew all along. Okay?
Yeah,
are you typing?
Yeah.
Are you typing? Are you sending me a private message? Are you like, Pippa, we can't talk about that, Pippa. They're gonna shut us down, Pippa.
Do you think I care about them shutting me down?
Oh, who's I'm them? Who's them? Channel. Are you using racist dog whistles now?
Sweet! Sweet!
Okay, how old is he? He looks like he's like... Well, if the main characters are like 10, then this is probably like 7. Because the show is like from the perspective of like these children. Right?
Yeah, like Rugrats.
Yeah, exactly.
He's not actually, though.
Oh, how old is he?
He's 5.
That does not look like a 5-year-old. That was close.
Well, that's a 5-year-old. It's a Canadian 5-year-old. They're built different.
No, they're built weak because they don't drink enough milk growing up.
Actually, Canadians have a lot of milk growing up because Canadian farmers lobby very hard. They're probably the biggest lobbyist party in Canada. So they keep
the milk
Canadians.
People?
Yes.
What the
yes.
fuck?
Yes. It's actually a conspiracy.
I need to look into this later. What the fuck? Okay, name
Canadian
him.
Canadian milk is very expensive.
Yeah, it comes in like a bag for some reason.
Only on the East Coast.
That's so weird.
Yeah.
That's weird.
Okay, who do you think this Canadian's related to?
Broflovsky? That sounds like a Canadian name.
It kind of does. It kind of really does.
Yeah, it does. Like a Russian immigrant to Canada. Maybe? Who is
Jewish immigrants, but yes.
I knew that. Okay! Listen, I am the opposite of stereotyper, all right? I'm so unracist, I can't even stereotype, right? Okay, so there you go. Checkmate.
Checkmate?
Yeah. Who is the youngest?
Oh, I actually don't know this one. I think
really?
I might.
I'm gonna say Kenny. Because he always dies in the show, right?
Yeah, I would also go Kenny for that one.
So he probably gets bullied the most. Oh wait, I know this one's name. His name is...
Okay.
Token Black.
Yeah, it's Token Black.
Yeah.
Such like a Hobbit name. Writer.
Yeah. What? No, that's yeah. Tolkien.
Yes, Token Black.
Oh, okay. All right. This guy, this is Timmy? Question mark? Wait, we just saw him. We just saw him in the game.
Yes.
He's not Timmy. Timmy is the one that goes, Timmy!
Yes. But you're close?
I'm close?
You're close?
Is this Bradley Bickle?
No.
Marcus Preston?
No.
Jimmy!
But he doesn't actually say Jimmy. So,
but it is Jimmy.
It is Jimmy.
I'm so smart. Oh, that's Ember.
Yeah.
Ember's in South Park?
Yeah, totally.
She's gotta be a goth kid, right?
Ooh. You shouldn't say that.
Why?
Ooh.
Why? Goth isn't a race. I'm allowed to stereotype them.
It's not one
racially
of the goth
profile.
Kids. There's a whole episode about this. This is a whole episode.
Oh?
Yeah.
Is she emo then? She's like, I'm not goth. I'm emo. Okay, it's different. I cut myself.
Actually, yes, that is the difference. That's actually the difference.
Oh, fuck off,
I'm not
Dizzy.
Gonna explain.
Fuck off. Is she emo?
No, not quite. Even worse.
She's part of the KKK.
I mean, she might be, but even worse.
Even worse than the KKK.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Imagine a group of children that establish them purely through fan fiction.
Oh, she's a vampire kid.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, fan fiction, there we go. Yeah. Is she writing Twilight fan fiction?
Yes.
Yeah. You probably heard this a million times, but for the members of the audience who don't know, 50 Shades of Grey was actually Twilight fanfiction originally. It was called, like, Masters of the Universe. And it was
Have you read the original? Have you read the original fanfiction, Pippa?
I have not. Have you?
Mm-hmm. No, I can't say I have.
Oh, maybe that could be a collab.
The original.
Yeah. The original unedited.
There's a couple of South Park fanfictions that actually got published into books.
What?
There's one that's really, the book itself is not famous, but the fanfiction is famous, I think, within the community. But people don't know that it was, people don't know that it was published into a book. Not very many people know. The fanfiction is called Raisins Boy.
Raisins Boy? That sounds very homoerotic.
Yep.
Oh, well, no, I'm not surprised.
I forgot what the published book is called.
Is it scatological?
I don't think there's scat, but there's Black Jesus in it.
Is Black Jesus a character in South Park?
No. No, this was just the author's own thing.
Well, to their credit, it sounds like something that could be in South Park. So good job on that.
Yeah, honestly.
Now I'm gonna Google it. Hold on. You said it's called Raisins Boy?
Raisins Boy? I don't know if it's still up.
Raisins Boy South Park.
Raisins Boy South Park.
Oh, this I'm not seeing
anything. This is very, very old. But you might find raisins, so that gives you an idea of what it is. I think most of your audience who watches South Park won't know about this because this is only well known in a very specific subsection of a fandom.
Okay, so it looks like Raisins is Hooters. So I'm gonna go out on a limb and I'm gonna say the plot of this is one of the boys starts cross-dressing to work at Raisins and nobody can know that he's actually a boy. And then one of the other characters finds out that he's actually a boy and then starts blackmailing him into doing homoerotic deeds.
It's pretty close. You're pretty close. You're about like 50% there.
Oh, only 50%. Okay, what's the actual plot?
Okay, so it's an AU story. One of the boys, the little Jewish one, works at Raisins. I don't know, something with, I can't remember.
Are Raisins kosher?
Huh?
Are Raisins kosher?
Surely.
Okay, sorry, continue.
I don't remember the exact plot because I read that when I was massively underage.
Daisy, where were your parents?
What parents? Anyways, there's a reason I'm a VTuber.
True, and you're dressed like that.
Anyways, something sodomy, Stan is emo, something smoking cigarettes.
I like that.
Who's that one guy who touched little kids in real life? He's like a popular...
Jason from Subway! Is his name Jason? John? Todd?
He's black.
Jared from Subway. Okay, he's not black. Bill Cosby? Michael Jackson?
Bill Cosby. Oh, Bill Cosby. I think it was Bill Cosby. He was something?
Listen, Dizzy. He didn't touch children. He just raped women. It's very different.
Allegedly. My mistake. I'm sorry, Chad. Yeah. I'm sorry for making that terrible mistake.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think Bill Cosby was Black Jesus or something. And
that's
there was
oddly
a hospital
specific.
Scene. And anyways, it became a novel of some sort. And I think the author has since had to like take it down because it became a published novel. And that's why you can't find it anymore. But then the novel didn't even do that well.
What the Raisins South Park fan fiction. Wait, was it Kylex Stan?
It was Kylex Stan. Is it still up?
I don't know. It started to autocomplete.
They found it. They found it.
Is it
Bill Cosby? Is it Bill Cosby, chat? It might be a different famous black person.
Why you gotta keep specifying race? It's kind of weird, Dizzy. It's kind of weird.
Sorry, I should work on not evil giggling every couple seconds.
Yeah. Yeah. It doesn't help your case at all. Oh, R. Kelly.
Anyway.
Wait, that makes sense. Because R. Kelly...
Oh, it was R. Kelly?
Yeah. Maybe. But he's the one who peed on little girls.
Okay, that's why I thought it was...
Yeah, now, Bill Cosby, that would have been ahead of his time. I said his time, but realistically, the author was probably a woman.
Definitely a woman.
Yeah. Okay, what's his last name? Is it something silly like Biggle? Is he like, I'm Biggly Emo?
I know his first name, but I actually don't know his last name.
I'm just gonna guess Biggle.
Okay, good enough.
When do the goth kids first appear? Butt out? Are you out there, God? It's me, Jesus. Pip! Proper condom use or Raisins?
Have you seen the character Pip yet? Where you are in the game? I don't know if he's in the first game, actually.
I haven't seen
him. Okay.
Is he cool? Is he a cool kid? Does he have cool?
No.
Oh.
Absolutely not.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay,
sorry.
Well, don't spoil it. I'll see either in the clips or in the game.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I don't actually think I have any clips of him, but we can find one.
Do you know the answer to this?
Yes, I do, actually.
Oh my fucking god, you nerd. You watch this show in order?
Yeah, several times a year, actually.
Oh my god.
I regularly rewatch the show.
You are so mentally ill.
From season 1 to season 26 every year.
26? There's 26 seasons?
Yeah! Sometimes I watch it multiple times in a year.
What
you see,
fuck?
I have a brand of autism where I can only enjoy things I've already enjoyed. So realistically, I only have 4 shows I watch.
You should consider buying cable television just so you can't do that thing that you keep doing.
But it makes me happy.
You need to diversify your interests, Dizzy. This isn't healthy.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do. Jesus fucking Christ. 26 seasons. How long does that take you?
If I don't shower?
Okay.
A couple weeks.
You're sick. You're sick in the head. Okay, I'm gonna say the goth kids first appear in season 3, episode 16.
Wrong answer.
Oh god, what's the right answer?
They appeared raisins in season 7.
Oh my god, not this raisin shit again.
Raisins is iconic.
How many vampire kids are there? I'm gonna say 6. Like 6, 6, 6.
Off the top of my head, I remember there were like 4 main ones, but yeah, maybe it's 6. I feel like there's more than that.
What's his name?
There's actually an episode where there's a whole meeting of vampire kids, and they actually grew like quite large. Like their group of vamp kids grew very large.
Are you invested in the plot of the vampire kids? Goth kids and shit?
No, the goth kids are cool, but vampire kids plot was incredibly fucking lame. But what's his name, guys? What's his name?
Is it Mysterion? And he's like a parody of Mysterio?
No, but you'll get that later.
Oh. Is he Professor Chaos?
Yeah, actually.
I'm so fucking cracked. Okay, this is the mosquito.
Yes.
Okay.
So the second South Park game that I assume that you're not going to play unless Tenma absolutely twists your hand into it is... Well, it's a superhero thing. It happened during the whole craze of Marvel movies.
Oh.
Yeah.
Making fun of cape shit?
Yes.
Yeah. Nice. Okay, is this right? The goth kids? What click the skip?
Yes.
Oh, I'm so smart. What is Eric Cartman's middle name? No middle name?
I don't think so.
The Grand Wizard King, Eric Cartman and the Sick of Truth, is part of which kingdom? The Kingdom of Koopa Keep. I know that one.
Correct.
I paid attention. Who's the main character? Well, Cartman?
No, technically not.
No?
Okay, here's a hint. The main characters are based on the creators because Vernarxis is a piece of shit.
I don't know the fucking creators' names. Who made the show?
You know, I should know this, actually.
Oh my god, she does it now!
Trey Parker and Matt Stone.
Oh my god, she does it now! There's no characters
big
here
fan,
named Trey.
Big fan.
Or what was their names? Trey Parker or Matt Stone?
And Matt Stone, yeah.
There's no characters here named Matt or Trey.
Okay, but like, what are the most generic white male names?
Craig.
On this list. Actually, okay, you know, I walked right into that one.
Kyle?
He's technically one of the main characters, but not quite.
Stan.
Yes.
Ah, there we go.
There you go.
What season do the kids enter fourth grade? Oh my god, they grow up.
Oh, this is an easy one. Yeah, they start this series in third grade.
So, I'm gonna say 11.
Season 4.
Oh my god. I can't believe they actually grow up.
That's the only time you see them grow up in a time skip episode in the COVID special.
In the COVID special?
Yeah.
We gotta take the answers now. Okay, Kyle was correct. Kenny was incorrect for the long lost brother.
Who is Scott Tenorman.
Scott Tenorman. Okay. Correct. He's not Islamic. He's not 7.
Hey, it's the same thing.
Yeah, same thing.
Yeah.
His name is not Token Black.
It's Token Black. Come on, I'm saying it.
Oh, Tolkien.
All right, so let me explain this. So he originally was named Token Black, but then in a recent season, you know, I guess the creators realized that it was inappropriate to name a character Token Black. So they redacted it, changed everything to Token Black, and made it the whole premise of the episode, where Stan and Stan's father have been calling him Token the whole time. And everyone else in this town knew that his name was Token, technically. And then they were just like, dude, that's racist. And then they were just like, but his name is Token! Anyway,
how
so yeah,
it?
they gaslit the audience.
Oh,
they changed the wiki,
okay.
They changed the website, they changed everything.
What the fuck?
I'm actually curious whether or not they patched Stick of Truth to have his name as Tolkien.
It does say Tolkien, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, on the gate when you walk in. His last name is not Bigel. What is it?
I'm gonna say it's probably because Biggles is the fat goth girl, so I think he's probably, his first name is Pete. I'm gonna say it's probably Thelman?
Chat, what's his last name? Oh yeah, they're saying Thelman.
Yeah, nice.
Oh my god, you fucking nerd. Okay, it does not say how many vampire kids there were, it just says six is incorrect.
I actually don't know this one.
It doesn't say. This is so dumb. Why doesn't it correct me? Dad, do you know? Any South Park superfans in here who know? Oh, five?
Someone said, wasn't Thelman the Lisp kid? No, it's not. It's Scott Malkinson, you loser.
Oh my god. Oh my fucking god. No middle name is
Eric
incorrect.
I didn't know Eric had a middle name.
Fake fan!
I'm sorry.
Chat, super fans who are googling all the answers to this and they themselves have never actually watched the show before?
Apparently it's Theodore. We're saying it's Theodore.
Theodore? That seems like it'd be like the premise to an episode, like making fun of how stupid his middle name is.
I don't think it actually was. I don't think there is an episode about that.
No?
No.
Okay, Well, all right. Would you like to watch some clips now?
Yeah.
All right. I'm gonna hit the play button. Fuck.
Okay, so this is one of the most iconic songs from South Park. This is Kyle's Mom.
Kyle's Mom. Oh, there's no audio for me. Oh, because I have it muted.
Okay, nice.
Children, I'm really that checks out. Our time with our Christmas play. The new law states we can't sing any songs having to do with Jesus or Santa Claus.
Thanks to Kyle's mother.
This is
so
actually from season one.
Santa or non-Jesus Christmas songs.
Mm-hmm. Was season one the funniest, and every other season after
Kyle's
is just downhill?
Is a stupid bitch in D minor.
No, not actually. I would say it. The humor kind of changes. Around season 6? Yeah!
What the fuck is that?
That's a Mr. Hanky? He's a Christmas poo.
Golly, that isn't very nice. I'd sure like to teach him a lesson.
Have you ever
seen
she's the biggest bitch in the whole wide world? She's a mean old bitch and she has stupid hair. She's a bitch. She's a stupid bitch.
Stupid bitch!
I'm not a bitch and she's just a dirty bitch. Kyle's mom is a bitch.
Which one is Kyle?
What the?
Ew.
But
ew.
You.
Ew.
The Jew.
Oh. I was saying you to the Jew. I was saying you to the shit hitting his face.
Yeah.
I'd like to clarify that. Yeah, that is gross.
So they eventually basically write off Mr. Hanky because he's gross.
What? Where did Mr. Hanky come from?
He's just the Christmas poo.
And where did the Christmas poo come from?
Your toilet.
Whose toilet?
Everyone's toilet.
He's like Santa Claus, but a piece of shit?
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
You understand this perfectly. So we want you to this clip is City Walk Guy Builds a Great Wall.
I don't build wall. I just own and operate a City Walk.
We just think that you're the best person to put up a wall. We're sure you've got it in your blood.
Oh, I get it. Just because I'm Chinese, you think I build a wall.
He's not actually Chinese. Did you know that? Okay?
Just because I'm Chinese doesn't mean I go
around
building walls.
He's Mongolian?
I'm just a normal person like all you.
No. He's a therapist.
I'm not a stereotype.
Please, Mr. Tuang Lu Kim.
I don't think therapist is a race.
Well, we'll get into it. I'll explain it after this clip.
Oh my god, he did it.
He did it. But wait. The Mongolians!
What the fuck?
Hey. The Mongolians!
What the fuck?
Hey, what the hell are you doing? Mongolian? What the hell Mongolian doing here?
I hate the Mongolians!
Break down my wall?
What the fuck?
Get out of here, fucking Mongolian! God damn it, how come every time us Chinese put up a wall, stupid Mongolians have to come and knock it down?
He said he's Chinese!
No, okay, so this is a spoiler for a later season. So, in a later season, Butters starts a race war, an Asian race war. Very common occurrence, actually. And as a result, he gets put into therapy, and turns out his therapist has multiple personalities, and his therapist is actually a white guy, and one of his personalities is a Chinese shitty walk owner.
That seems a little questionable.
Yes!
So he's... This was a white man?
Yes! Let me see if I can find a clip, actually. What's his name?
Oh, sir, Amano Serapy, thank you for the raid!
Thank you for the raid!
We're looking at South Park stuff. I'm learning about South Park.
And you're learning so much.
Yeah. Like, this is a white man who owns a city walk.
And you gotta say it with an accent. Shitty walk.
Ooh, I don't wanna be I don't need more stuff added to the Twitlongers. These clips get quieter and quieter.
And when you get to the top of that tower, you're gonna get a little surprise, you Japanese. Oh, sorry. Anyway, see you on top of tower.
We had a gain to this.
Yeah.
Dr. Janice sure has a big house, doesn't he? He's planning on hurting people, I just know it!
It's okay, so this is one of Dr. Janice's split personalities. Kind of
you're Inspector Butters and I'm your faithful assistant, Dr. Watson.
Alright, Watson. Well, let's find out what we need to and get out of here.
Yeah!
Butters has kind of
Butters,
a cute voice.
What are you doing in my house?
He's very cute.
Oh,
Butters is a cute
character.
It's okay, character.
Butters. You just think you're Inspector Butters right now.
Except he grows up to sell
Come on,
you NFTs.
Let's get you home.
Oh.
Where are you going, Butters?
Depends on the AU, though. Depends on the AU.
You aren't leaving here, Inspector. None of you are!
What the fuck?
Butters, come on! Try and come back to us!
You can't run forever!
Excuse me, did someone order a pizza? Yes, that was me, but I'm a little busy at the moment. I'll be right back.
You'll never turn me in, Inspector Butters! You're dead!
What the fuck is going on?
This is probably one of my favorite episodes from this season.
You wanna take over my city walk?
Holy crap, what time is it? Oh no, I'm late!
That's not allowed! What the fuck?
What took you so long?
Can nobody tell?
Yes, my tower of peace was a little bit of trickery, Mr. Japanese dog. I'm going to put an end to you. And everyone gonna think it's just because you did what Japanese people love doing most. No, don't do it! Don't kill yourself, please!
I'm not going to kill myself!
No, don't be a priest!
Did you get the joke?
I got the joke! What the fuck?
This is South Park Police!
Police? How?
We know the truth, Dr. Janice!
It's the Chinese rat trying to kill me!
He's not Chinese, he's white.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Your name is Dr. Janice.
You people crazy.
Listen to them, it's true.
Truth hurts, doesn't it, Janice?
What
Who
the
are
fuck?
You people? Why are you all here?
Yes.
How could I let myself believe white man was a Chinese? I have brought shame upon myself. No, this is racial stereotype.
Oh, okay. Well, that explains one of the scenes in Stick of Truth.
Yes. Yes, it does.
What
now,
the fuck?
Now, one thing about me is I reference everything I like far too much on my channel because I don't have a lick of creativity.
Are you putting on a bad Chinese accent and saying Mongolians?
Only in, like, two streams.
And attacking Japanese people?
Only in, like, two streams.
Dizzy! Jesus Christ!
So the next one you might recognize if you've watched any of my videos.
Wait, hold on. I have a
Hello,
question though.
I'm Tony Hayward.
Yes.
Okay. So there's... Okay, this is like a culture question. Okay.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so like in Chinese, like, there's L sounds.
Yes.
So why... In South Park, does the character that's doing a Chinese accent replace the L's with R's?
Wait, armor? L sounds in Chinese? I don't think there's actually L sounds.
Wait, hold on. Okay, I cannot speak Chinese for shit, right? But like... Like, E-R, San, Sh, well, Leo, right? Like, six?
E-R, San, Su, W.
Leo, Chi, Ba. Right?
Li, Ba. Yeah, I guess there are L sounds.
So, like... Why does the accent turn it into R's? Oh yeah, like Lo Main, although I don't know if that's like a real Chinese thing or like a fucking...
It is, I think.
Oh, okay.
I don't know, I'm like...
Let's ask Sakuna.
Yeah, let's ask Sakuna.
Sakuna, if I were to do a racist caricature... How do you spell caricature? Caricature. Hold on, let me show you
it's
on the
okay.
screen too. Caricature.
It's okay, he probably can't spell it either.
Of your accent, should I use L sounds or only R sounds? Like Mongolian. Fuck. Mongolian. Okay, we'll see how he responds.
Yeah. Until then, let's get to the next clip.
Okay.
You guys might recognize this if you've watched any of my videos. Self-plug!
Self-plug?
This is a self-plug!
President and CEO of BP. Our accidental drilling spill again in the Gulf is a tragedy that should have never happened. And to all those affected, I want to say, we are deeply sorry. We're sorry.
Oh, I've seen
We're
you do
We're sorry.
This.
Yeah.
You did this
We're for sorry.
Weekly. Mm-hmm.
Sorry.
Sorry.
We're sorry. We're sorry.
What the fuck?
Sorry. We're sorry. I'm deeply sorry. Sorry.
What the fuck?
Okay, so when there was a BP oil spill, BP actually put out a sorry video that was just this bad.
Wait,
like, this is almost like 100% real to life.
Do you have that? Can we put that on?
Yeah, let me find it real quick.
The little baby seal. He's petting a baby seal.
It's covered in oil.
Oh no, because BP. Actually, I don't remember what happened with the BP oil spill, like, that made it happen. Wasn't it, like, safety regulations or something weren't being abided?
Something boat. Hmm. Here's Hayward's apology. Here's a real one.
We're sorry for the massive disruption it's caused to their lives. And, you know, there's no one who wants this thing over more than I do. You know, I'd like my life back. So there's no one who wants this thing done more than I do. And we are doing everything we can to contain the oil offshore, defend the shoreline, and return people's lives to normal as fast as we can. And there's just no effort being spared in any dimension.
I mean, that was kind of like a harmless apology.
Yeah, but... you know. So shitty apology. Anyways...
Oh, I mean, it's like an interview! What else do you want him to say? They did an actual ad!
Maybe actually do something.
There's an ad?
I think so.
Does anybody have the name of the ad?
Oh, I think I have it. Hold on. Let's get it.
The Gulf spill is a tragedy that never should have happened. I'm Tony Hayward. BP has taken full responsibility for cleaning up the spill.
There we go. This is what I was looking for.
We've helped organize the largest environmental response in this country's history. More than 2 million feet of boom, 30 planes, and over 1,300 boats are working to protect the shoreline. Where oil reaches the shore, thousands of people are ready to clean it up. We will honor all legitimate claims, and our cleanup efforts will not come at any cost to taxpayers.
I'm a bird!
To those affected and your families, I'm deeply sorry. The Gulf is home for thousands of BP employees, and we all feel the impact. To all the volunteers, and for the strong support of the government, thank you. We know it is our responsibility to keep you informed and do everything we can so this never happens again.
There's no one who wants this thing over more than I do. You know, I'd like my life back.
Thoughts, feelings, opinions?
Okay, the I want my life back part is kind of out of touch.
Yeah,
a little bit out of touch. But like, other than that, it's not horrible. It's not horrible. It could be like don't you guys have phones moment.
I think your standard for apologies is just lowered because we've now been through so many shitty YouTuber apologies.
True.
Have we had a shitty VTuber apology yet?
Huh?
Have we had a shitty VTuber apology yet?
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Was it within the company?
Listen, some people claim I apologized, alright? But, no.
People would never.
But, I don't know, I think the things that makes VTuber apologies so shitty is usually, like, they make, like, a public apology, but then they, like, go behind people's backs and then, like, say some dumb shit that, like, cancels out their apology, and then it gets screen-capped.
Well, that's because a VTuber could never, never be the villain in any scenario because, you know, all VTubers were nerdy bullied kids in high school, so now they have some sort of weird victim complex.
True. They're just like me, for real?
I know. It's like looking into a mirror.
Anyways.
On victim complex, let's talk about Eric Cartman's secret brother.
Okay.
All right, I guess we should taste each other's chili, huh?
Yeah, this chili looks pretty good. Here's mine.
Mm. This is his brother?
I don't know. Your chili is good, Cartman.
Yeah, but he doesn't know it at this point.
All right.
Is it going to be his mom's recipe?
Hey, this is great.
Yeah, it's a family recipe.
This is really good, Scott.
I'm glad you like it so much, because now that you're almost finished, I have something to tell you.
What? You mean about how you put pubes in your chili?
What?
Yes, I'm afraid this isn't your chili, Chef. It's delicious, Chef. I hadn't planned on that. What I did plan on, however, was that my friend Stan and Kyle would betray me and warn you that the Chili Con Carnival was a trap. I assumed that they would tell you that I had trained Dankin's pony to bite off your wiener. What they didn't tell you was that Dankin's is a crazy redneck who shoots trespassers on sight. Knowing that you would go and try to do something to the pony, I warned Mr. Dankin's that violent pony killers were in the area. I also knew that you wouldn't go yourself for fear of having your wiener bitten off. You would most likely send your parents. And I'm afraid that when Mr. Dankin's spotted them on his property, he shot and killed both your parents.
Oops! What the fuck?
I should have warned you about the guns.
I have my rights.
My
Castle Doctrine!
I came just in time.
Stand your ground!
Yeah!
And of course, to steal the bodies. After a night with the hacksaw, I was all ready to put on my Chili Con Carnival so that I could tell you personally about your parents' demise. And of course, feed you your chili. Do you like it? Do you like it, Scott?
Do you like for chili?
I call it Mr. and Mrs. Tenorman chili.
Oh my god! Oh my god!
What the fuck?
Jesus Christ, dude!
My mom and dad are dead!
What the fuck?
No!
Excuse me.
Who are you?
We're that band.
Linkin Park!
Jeez, what a little cry.
Radiohead?
Are you gonna cry all day, crybaby?
Same difference.
You know, everyone has problems. It doesn't mean you have to be a little crybaby about it.
Come on, guys, let's go. This kid is totally not cool.
Yeah, that's the most uncool.
Totally not cool.
Little crybaby.
Is that really them?
No, wait.
I don't actually know. It might be. There's a lot of celebrity guesses on the show. Yeah, that's Scott Tenorman's favorite band, by the way.
Oh.
Your tears are so yummy and sweet.
Tears!
To never piss Cartman off again. Good call. Oh, the tears of unfair.
Oh my god, what the fuck?
Yummy. Yummy, you guys. That's up.
Okay, Cartman's kind of based.
Yeah, this is, So up to this episode, Cartman's like a little bit of an asshole, but he's still like, you know, they still treat him as just like a kid.
Uh-huh.
Just like a regular kid.
A kid that murders people?
Yeah. Well, don't worry. Scott Tenorman has a vengeance episode.
Oh?
I think you might actually see it in the game at some point. I don't know if that's spoilers. Tenorman revenge. Let me pull that up.
Oh, Radiohead did voice their characters.
Oh, that's awesome.
Tenorman has killed more people than a nuclear bomb.
Well, to be fair, I think most of the characters on the show have, like, a very, very long crime list.
Even Butters?
Oh, Butters! Butters has done a lot.
What has Butters done? He seems so innocent and pure and kickable.
Pimping?
Oh. Well,
fraud?
Then... Oh.
Terrorism?
Terrorism? What'd he do?
I think he joined an anti-China group and may have shot 3 people as a result.
What the fuck? Context?
No, that was full context.
Oh, okay. You know, as one does, commit terrorism against the Chinese. You just do it. Okay.
I mean, I think boys have joined several terrorism groups. Pirate groups.
Oh, Sakuna responded.
Yeah. What did he say?
He said, what the fuck?
That's not an answer, Sakuna. That's not an answer at all.
L sound or no L sound.
See, should have another clip for you. This is one of my favorites. So one thing about South Park is it does get quite preachy sometimes. Specifically Kyle gets really preachy.
Preachy about what?
Anything and everything.
You said he's Jewish?
Yeah.
Is he preaching, like, literally? Like, preaching the Bible?
I think only in one episode does he preach anything religious. But this is probably my favorite speech. Fun fact about the speech is it was never actually showed on TV because it was censored. But someone managed to find it, I believe, on the South Park website because they had, like, due to an error.
They just uploaded everything without fucking thinking?
Yeah.
To the South Park website? Okay, that checks out. Wait, there's, like, deep lore with South Park about, like, like, the portrayal of, like, a certain religious deity, right? That got, like... And a certain, Western religion...
Play the clip!
Okay.
The following episode appeared as it originally aired on April 21, 2010. After it aired, Matt Stone and Trey Parker released the following statement. In the 14 years we've been doing South Park, we have never done a show that we couldn't stand behind. We delivered our version of a show to Comedy Central and they made a determination to alter the episode. It wasn't some meta jokes on our part. Comedy Central added the bleeps. In fact, Kyle's customary final speech was about intimidation and fear. Bah! Anyways, fuck Comedy Central. Wait, can I say that?
Why not?
You killed your own father, and then you fed him to your half-brother! Yes! Yes!
The reveal!
Now eat your chili! The super best friends! Oh no!
Oh, this is what I was thinking of!
So did you, Tom?
Yeah!
Hey, look, Tom Cruise has semen on his back.
What did you say?
Oh, yeah, Tom Cruise does have semen on his back.
I guess maybe Tom Cruise likes semen.
Whoa, you're not supposed to be able to make fun of me anymore. What the hell's going on?
I'll be back, super best friends.
Who's the creepy ginger kid?
Reiner, you said the goo machine would work, but I got made fun of.
That's because there is no goo, Mr. Cruise. You see, I learned something today. Throughout this whole ordeal, we've all wanted to show things that we weren't allowed to show. But it wasn't because of some magic goo. It was because of the magical power of threatening people with violence. That's obviously the only true power. If there's anything we've all learned, it's that terrorizing people works.
That's right. Don't you see, Gingers? If you don't want to be made fun of anymore, all you need are guns and bombs to get people to stop.
That's right, friends. All you need to do is instill fear and be willing to hurt people, and you can get whatever you want. The only true power is violence.
Yeah.
That's kind of based.
Honestly, yeah, hearing this speech again in the year 2023, no words have ever rung truer. Anyways, fun fact, all the little ginger kids that you see in this clip. So there is an episode dedicated to ginger kids and how they don't have souls. It actually resulted, I don't know how widespread the movement was, but they started a national Kick a Ginger Day.
I heard about
like
that.
There were like news reports on ginger kids getting kicked because of South Park.
Sakuna responded, by the way.
Well, that's a message to you, not a message to me. So for my next trick, I...
Listen, management only said that I can't be racist. Dizzy, on the other hand.
I get a pass.
No one knows you're race, it's fine.
Minority enough, I'm literally an elf bug.
Elf bug?
Elf bug, I'm whatever it is to be convenient.
Did you kick any gingers?
Have I kicked a ginger?
Yeah.
No, I don't think I've kicked any gingers. Have you kicked any gingers before?
Well, no, but I'm not a South Park fan. But if I was a South Park fan, oh yeah, I would have.
Yeah, yeah, that's totally fair. I think that's absolutely fair.
Is this where the whole ginger hate thing started from? Like, because, do you know that video where it's like, we do have souls! Gingers have souls!
Yes, this is probably what it came from.
Actually, hold on, doesn't he, like, reference South Park? Hold on. Gingers have souls.
Yeah, put the video on.
Yeah. Gingers do have souls.
That's Copper Cab, right?
Yeah!
That's Copper Cab?
The man, the myth, the legend.
I just wanted to say that... it really irritates me that South Park would say that...
There we go!
...don't have souls, okay?
It was! Oh my god!
We do have souls, alright? And lately I've been being called a ginger. A fat ginger. By everybody at school.
I mean, that's just objective. Is it really calling you a name if that's just what you are?
And it really hurts my feelings.
Lose some weight!
Yeah, fat ass!
I like it doesn't, but it does really bad. Gingers have souls! I go to church. I'm a Christian.
He's a Christian.
You don't know me. You're not God. You're not God. You don't know who has a soul and who doesn't, alright? I'm a Christian.
The way he, like, twitches threateningly.
Think I don't have a soul?
He's gonna kick your ass through the camera, Dizzy. You better watch it.
Otherwise, fuck you.
No, fuck you.
Fuck you!
For real. I'm getting tired of everyone making fun of red-haired people.
This is 3 minutes long.
He's a ginger! He's a ginger!
Well, let's take a short music break with really, my favorite Kanye West song.
One thing I know, my girl ain't no hobbit. She might be stupid, that don't mean she a hobbit.
Yeah. Is this a real Kanye?
She couldn't be. No, it's not.
Oh.
She got no Bagginses in her family tree.
Yeah.
Yes, on occasion she hangs out with her dwarf friends. But she never went on no quest with her dwarf friends. Except for one time she went to kill that dragon. She took its gold and she... Hang on a minute, I'm sorry.
Oh, okay.
Remember when you went off to kill that dragon with them dwarves? Yeah. Oh, yeah. Right. Yep, I got it. Yep, love you too. It wasn't no dragon, so my girl ain't no hobbit.
Ain't no hobbit.
That was a Quiznos and my...
Kim Kardashian was livid about being made fun of and considers this an unnecessary attack.
While she drinking her grog and singing those merry songs. Kanye West also was not very happy about this.
Well, he's not happy about anything.
Tell me I'm not engaged to no hobbit.
Well, you know, years later, and by years later, I mean literally last year, I think he realized what the jokes meant. Like, he finally realized what the jokes meant.
He was just, like, confused
tweeted,
before?
Like, yes, genuinely.
Oh.
And what? So he tweeted, like, that's a funny joke, actually. Like, I get it now. Like, yeah.
Oh, it took him a couple years, but he figured it out.
Yeah.
There's
that's character development.
Yeah, there's an AI Kanye version of this. There we go, now it's the real Kanye. Technology's great.
Technology's amazing.
She hangs out with her dwarf friends, but she never went on no quest with her dwarf friends. Except for one time she went to kill that dragon. She took its gold and she... Hang on a minute, I'm sorry.
Oh, it doesn't do talking very well.
No.
Bitch, remember when you went out to kill that dragon with them dwarves?
Actually, this part's pretty solid.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
He's still got like a feminine accent though.
Yeah. Love you too.
Mm.
It wasn't no dragon, so my girl ain't no hobbit. That was a Quiznos and my bitch went to rob it. Cause they got that ham that she rubs on her cellulite. While she drinking her grog and singing those merry songs at night. My girl ain't
Did
no
Kim
hobbit.
Kardashian really rob a Quiznos?
I'm not engaged to no hobbit.
Not to my knowledge, but Ariana Grande did lick a bunch of donuts.
Yeah, there's footage of like Ariana Grande. She was in, it was like a locally owned donut place too. Like it was like a small business that she did that to.
Yeah, I mean you can do a lot of bad things, but I feel like the minute you mess with an American small business, it's over for you.
It's all ogre now.
Yeah. Do you have any questions about South Park, by the way? Because I know you're playing through the game right now. Do you have a favorite character?
The one guy goes, okay. Or he goes like, okay.
Okay.
He's a silly little man.
Counselor. That's a counselor.
Counselor?
Mr. Mackey.
He's funny.
Yeah.
Wait, what do you know about that character? Tell me about him.
Tell you about Mr. Mackey.
Yeah.
Let's see. There's a... Oh, he got bad touch as a kid.
Oh. Oh, no.
Yeah. He got bad touch as a kid. When he went to camp. There's a whole episode where they go revisit his childhood and they find out he was bad touched by an owl.
An owl? Like the bird?
Yes.
He got raped by an owl?
Well, it was a guy in an owl costume, but
That's very different. That's very different. I was gonna say, owls, they do not have, like, penises or nothing. So, like...
Well, you know.
Okay. So a man in an owl costume diddled Mr. Mackey, you said his name is?
Yes, and it resulted in intense trauma.
Oh, is he scared of owls? Can you walk up behind him and say, like, whoo, and he pisses himself?
You know, I'm not exactly sure, but we could try.
We could try, okay.
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Mr. Mackey...
Oh, he's a hoarder.
Oh, is he a hoarder? There's not a lot of Mr. Mackey things I know. Let's see.
Wait, okay, tell me about your favorite character and why. Why are they your favorite character?
My favorite character is Craig.
Craig?
I don't know if you've met him yet.
I don't think so.
There's like the other boys that the boys hang out with. So there's two groups. There's like Kyle and Stan's group, like Stan, the main characters. And then there's like Craig's gang. And it's like basically the other popular boys in fourth grade. Mm. And Craig's, well,
are they like
Craig's
from a different
gang,
class or?
They're all in the same. Well, they all switch classes here and there. Like there are some characters that get moved around quite often. So the classes do change.
Mm.
Craig has a gang. Yeah, Craig has a gang. So it's Craig, Token, Clyde, Jimmy Tweak. Butters kind of comes in and out of it. But the characters do, like, get switched around quite a bit. So there's always four of them. The four members are, like, Craig and Token for sure and Clyde.
Why is everybody saying Fujo?
Oh, because... So there's a canon gay couple. There's a couple canon gay couples, I think, now. So there's a canon gay couple... In this show, they actually are the result. They actually, them being canon is the direct result of the game you're playing, because one of the people who worked on the game, while they were like looking for character references, they found all the Craig and Tweak BL. They found all the fan art of it, and they were just like, "This is fucking weird." And then they took that and they showed the other writers, and the other writers were inspired to make a whole episode about it.
And they, instead of shitting on the fans, they made it into...
They just ran with it.
Yeah,
they just ran with it, and now they are canon gay couple, and probably one of the healthiest gay couples I've ever seen on TV.
In South Park?
Yes.
Okay, well, that's not saying much. But alright. Alright, okay. Okay.
Yeah, they're a really sweet couple, because,
Okay, it's Craig and who?
Craig and Tweak.
Craig and Tweak. Right, you sent me fan fiction about them.
Yeah.
Listen, Dizzy, the cat's already out of the bag, alright?
I tell a story about this. So Emma came to visit me for 1 week. I was going through a really, really bad time when she came to visit me. So, you know, when I was going through this horrible, awful time, what else is there to do but read every single Craig X Tweak fan fiction on AO3?
I don't know, maybe not
so
do that?
We'd just be hanging out in public. Like, we'd be like, on transit. We'd be, like, at the museum.
And you're reading South Park porn on your phone.
Yeah. Yeah.
You're an exhibitionist. You're sick. You're sick. Just because it's woman porn doesn't mean it's not porn.
If anyone realizes that I'm reading porn, it's their fault for looking over my shoulder.
Oh, that's what, like, the high school teachers say on their work computers. They're like, oh, well, you shouldn't have been looking at my computer anyway, silly, naughty student.
Do you know how hard it is to read text on a little phone screen?
Listen, it can still happen, okay? It's more about you degrading public morals by engaging in such behavior. Alright?
First of all, I'm literally in bondage.
Yeah, on the internet! Are you admitting to going out in bondage in real life? Is that what you're doing? Is that what you're doing? You're walking around in bondage in real life, you sick fuck?
This is all canon! This is my real life! We're VTubers, Pippa! We're VTubers!
Oh my god. You know, even...
I'm canonically mold right now!
Even in VTuber lore, that doesn't mean that you have to wear... Listen. Okay, I'm not dressed like this all the time, right? I have an alt outfit, you know?
Must be nice!
Well, listen. I'm not saying you have to have an old outfit. I'm just saying, you know, you don't have to wear what you wear on stream when you... in your lore. In real life. In your virtual life. This is really complicated to talk about. This is hard. I can't articulate the... Like, there's ideas that I have that I want to say, but it's really fucking hard to communicate them.
Yeah, that's how most Dizzy collabs go.
You're a very confusing person.
Dizzy Ducker! Ducky Ducky Ducker!
Okay, Jesus Christ. Don't touch me! Don't touch me! Stay away from me! Okay, so Tweak is the little... He's the little tweaker. He does cocaine and coffee.
Well, he doesn't do cocaine. His coffee is laced with crystal meth.
Crystal meth?
Yes.
Okay. And his name is Tweak, but that's also his last name?
Yes, Tweak. Because Tweak. His parents are narcissists, so they named him after the coffee. Tweak.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. Okay, yeah, I looked up Tweak X Craig on YouTube. There's like a lot of stuff here.
Yeah, let's watch some of it. Actually, no, we shouldn't.
Nope, too late. I already...
Chat. Okay. I'm sorry, chat. We're watching Yaoi now.
Yeah, it's Yaoi time. I wanna try and understand what your fixation is here.
Okay, I'll try to explain it as we watch along.
Wait, I logged every single time Creek were together, standing next to each other, talked, were mentioned, etc.
Okay, so the
I found your old channel.
Tweak X Craig. So how this ship started is actually an episode from a very early season called Tweak versus Craig. Because what happens is the boys get bored and they're just like, hey, I bet I can make these guys fight. So they set up these kids to fight. And so there's just a scene of them rolling around half naked in the snow for like 30 seconds. 30 straight seconds, boys and girls. 30 straight seconds, chat. The most glorious 30 seconds of my fucking life. And that's the origin of the ship.
That's the origin of the ship. Two characters fighting naked in the snow.
Yeah.
Okay. It could be weirder.
Someone asked if I'm drooling. Yes, that's absolutely the noise, what you heard in my voice just now.
Yeah, Dizzy, aren't they children? Are we about to watch child porn?
Stealing your character?
Stealing. Craig chooses you. He wants to fight. He does? Yeah, he's all pissed off. Oh, it's so quiet again.
Why? Dude, because you have to stand up for yourself. So will you fight him? Ah, he doesn't look like he wants to fight me.
That one, this one's Craig? Wait, hold on.
The one with a hat. The one with a hat?
They're like all wearing hats, Dizzy.
Yeah, okay, this one is Craig. So his thing is he flips everyone off. That's his early characterization. But he's the toughest kid in third grade.
Wow.
Craig, I'm not normally one to get involved in this kind of thing, but... Well, I was just standing over by Tweak, and he called you a big poop eater.
Hey, Dad?
Yeah, he said you eat poop, and that it makes your breath smell like poop, and that... Well, you like it.
Why would he say that?
I don't know, Craig, I don't know. But now he's over there telling everybody that you're
cute?
A poop eater, and he chooses you.
Well, I've got to go over there.
No, Craig, you can't
cute?
Fight him here. Mr. Adder will just break
yeah,
it up.
Yeah, Craig's
you
so
what,
cute.
I'll go tell him you accept his challenge and set it up for after school today.
You're weird.
Okay.
I feel like objectively the best character is Cartman.
What a jerk! He's really got it out for you, dude.
Why?
He's
what
cute! very popular.
So do you need to fight him after school?
I guess so.
Super, see you there.
Hey, what's going on?
Tweak and Craig are gonna fight.
Really? Cool.
This isn't the fight, this is like the first
fight. It's funny, because Tweak and Craig both went home about 15 minutes ago.
Craig and I have no reason to fight each other!
Well, Craig showed up.
He did?
Yeah, he was standing there waiting for you, and he was all like, man, Tweak's a wuss. And we were all like, no, he's not, Craig. And he was all like, yeah, he is. He isn't showing up. He's a big wuss, and he has crooked teeth.
I don't have crooked teeth.
See, this is why we were still written like children.
Tweak scared of me. He's a big chicken. And he started doing an impersonation
like,
of you being a chicken.
Very, what the very hell? Real, I feel.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, why are they trying to make them fight again?
We're bored.
Oh, okay.
You're doing home. You're supposed to be out fighting Tweak.
Red Racer's on.
Craig, you can watch Red Racer any day of the week.
I do watch Red Racer every day of the week.
Well, that's fair.
Craig's
I guess
a little
you don't
autistic.
Care about what Tweak said about your man.
Nope.
That's why I like him.
God damn it.
Because he's just like you for real, for real?
I guess you don't care what Tweak said about your guinea pig.
What? What did
I'm
you say about
I'm not the strongest
Christ?
Kid in fourth grade.
You just wish, you know, that you were friends with the strongest kid in fourth grade. He would have protected you.
Probably not. He kind of hates everyone. That's kind of his thing.
Oh, okay. Never mind.
Son of a bitch. I'll kill
Except
him.
Except for guinea pig and his boyfriend.
Oh.
Wow, Tweak and Craig really hate each other, huh? This should be a good fight.
All right, here
so
we go.
So this is it. This is the big showdown that spawned everything.
No. This is the start. This is the Come first on. Fight. But they don't really fight each other here.
I've never been in a fight before.
Me neither!
Well, not like that. Like what then?
All right, screw this. We have to postpone the fight so Tweak and Craig can learn how to fight.
Very fair. If I teach Craig, he's gonna really kill Tweak.
Programs, get your programs here, programs.
Okay, now.
Now.
Okay.
Yeah.
Up.
Oh, yeah.
You're already getting off on this.
Yep.
You ready, Tweak?
You're
ready,
sick. Craig? You're sick in the head.
Let's get it on.
Respect
just,
my
just
authority.
Just wait for it. You'll get it. You'll get it. Oh, oh, oh.
Did you hear that?
What?
This is it, Dizzy? This is it? This is the whole thing?
Yeah.
Are you okay? You're not like touching yourself on my stream right now, are you?
Give me a minute to catch my breath.
Hey, we're here to visit our good friends Tweak and Craig.
What
was on the news?
You son of a bitch!
I'm gonna kick your ass.
Okay.
You're diagnosed with autism, right?
No, I figured life was more fun if it was 50-50.
Oh, okay.
Refuse to answer on the ground that it may incinerate me.
You could get diagnosed.
Incriminate.
Get out of the way! Move it! Can you see anything?
You should go.
It's harder when you're an adult.
I think it'd be easy for you, actually.
Do you think we could get, if we make it in the contract, you think we can get Sakuna to pay for it?
No, I don't think Sakuna's gonna pay for that.
I was telling Leah that one of my like hopes and dreams is for us all to get like CAT scans of our brains so we could compare our brains on stream.
What the fuck? How did you come up with that?
Well, think about it, because it shows all the trauma. It shows all the trauma so we could have a definitive who's the saddest.
How are we even gonna like compare them? None of us are like doctors or anything.
Well, I'm sure the doctor would explain it once we get it, so we just have to take notes and then we have to regurgitate whatever the doctors tell us. Or we could find a doctor. We could find one of those YouTube doctors and ask them to collaborate with us. And they can explain our brains to us.
Yeah, you find a doctor to collab with, Dizzy. We'll see. We'll go from there. We'll go from there. You find a doctor, all right?
There's okay, like, I'll do my best.
Yeah, there's like Dr. Mike and shit. There's a lot of them. I'm sure they would love to collab with VTubers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what? There's actually a nurse. There's a nurse VTuber, like a true nurse. You think she'd do it? You think she's trained to do it? I'm sure if we give her, like, a book, and we pay for the textbook, and we give her, like, 24 hours, she could do it.
She could learn how to, like, read brain scans?
Yeah!
You reach out, Dizzy. You reach out. You see if that can happen. You make that happen.
I'll do my best.
Okay. Okay. I'm seeing more weird Craig and Tweak shit. Is this what you watch, Dizzy?
Yeah, like all the time.
Oh, fuck this!
No! Not this! Not this!
Not this! Not this!
Shit on my screen!
No! Let it play! Let it play!
What the fuck is this?
What? You tell me! You tell me!
Trash!
Wait, which one is supposed to be which? These don't look like either of the characters.
So one thing about South Park fanfic offers is they, you know how South Park is kind of an edgy show?
Yeah.
They try to make it edgy, but in that weird Skins Gossip Girl way.
Like it's a girl show instead of a boy show?
Yeah.
Okay.
So there's always like infidelity and drug overdose, but not like the fun infidelity and drug overdose, like the, oh, you've ruined my mood way.
The like dramatic, like, oh my god, I can't believe he did this to me. I'm gonna go cry in my room and oh, this is setting up the big betrayal. I'm now gonna like revenge cheat, like that kind of thing.
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. All right.
But anyways, that's why we're watching Craig content. Let me get some of my favorite Craig content.
Some of your favorite Craig content? You got like a stash of that?
Well, there's this one episode kind of, well, that's quite popular, I think.
Wait, I found more of this shit. Hold on.
Please don't.
I found more of this.
You're welcome, chat. You're welcome.
Guinea rabbits are still everywhere.
Is this the pedophile one?
Guinea panthers. We've taken shelter at the Outback
Steakhouse. But there's multiple pedophile episodes.
Sharon and Shelly. Say hey, guys.
No, what character is the blue shirt guy?
Oh, that's Randy. He stands
down. What is that?
Oh.
I'm gonna take a look outside. What is it? It's a Guineasaurus Rex!
Ah! Oh, no! Oh, no!
Terrifying! It's terrifying!
Oh, my God!
I don't know. I'm way too startled.
Oh no, they're sending in the Air Force!
Jeez, they can't kill it!
Oh my god.
What do you think about the Guineasaurus Rex, Shelly?
Yes.
Oh, that's good. There's Shelly with the Guineasaurus Rex in the background.
The transition was so
cool. Give a little peace sign, Shelly.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I know. Hold out your palm so it looks like you're holding the Guineasaurus Rex.
You said that was Craig content?
Well, it was kind of his episode, but he actually isn't in most of this episode, I feel like.
But it's his episode?
But it's his episode.
So, tell me about Randy. I know Randy from the memes of him, like, sitting on the toilet with all, like, the sploosh all over his body.
Yeah. I'm surprised that's what you know Randy from. Okay, so Randy is Stan's dad, and early on in the series, his defining character trait is he's trying to be like a hip young dad. He's a little bit of a silly guy. He's a meteorologist, but eventually he quits that job to start a weed farm, thus starting one of South Park's most unbearable arcs, Tegrity Farms.
Unbearable? Tell me, Dizzy, tell me about your trauma from shitty show arcs.
Okay, so Tegrity Farms, Randy starts a farm. Where he grows weed and he moves his whole family out there, thereby displacing their entire lives. And the whole season of Tegrity Farms, I think it's maybe season 16, probably around there, something like that. It's all about him. And no one actually, like,
you
people like
witness
Randy,
some
but
real
people won't watch
history.
Stan, Kyle, Cartman,
back in the
and
day, George and
Kenny.
The founding fathers did have hemp farms because they knew the meaning of hard work and integrity.
Integrity.
Then our country did lose its way and began a war on drugs that was and still is just a war on people.
What the fuck?
And then a bunch of young corporate banker types come along telling us we're all in the new normal. As they try and turn God's green miracle into an easy buck for themselves. They even hire fancy Hollywood directors to make them look all hip and cool. But you know
the
what?
The production value is so
fuck
crazy.
Those guys, they ain't got no integrity.
Yeah.
The truth
yeah, South Park
is,
has come a long
has
way.
Always been people with integrity. All fighting for the one thing they can agree on. And that's why Tiggerty is donating 100% of profits to charities that work to right
the wrongs of
the
drug war. Is that a towel?
That's Towely. That's Towely.
You see, that's
Towely. The towel is a weed farmer?
No Tiggerty.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you want some?
I'll explain it in a bit. But
don't you wish everyone had some goddamn Tiggerty?
Damn Tiggerty.
Well, soon everyone can. Tiggerty weed.
Okay, so Tiggerty, or Towely, sorry. So Towely is a scientifically altered towel.
Uh-huh.
Who, in his, I think when he's first introduced, he's running away from his lab.
Uh-huh.
And so the thing about Towely is he just wants to be really high. Just wants to get real, real high.
What lab did he come from? Like, is he like a sham wow? Or like, why were they creating like sentient towels?
Well, I don't actually remember the episode too well. This is one of the very early ones. So like, there's this company called Tynacorp.
Uh-huh.
I think they're called Tynacorp. And they're like not actually humans, but they like manufactured Towely to spy on humans.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. And then he, like, works at a camp where he likes to get really high. And then they, like, forget about Towely for a bit until they, like, get to this episode with the crippled kids. And you find
Jimmy!
Out that Towely has... Yes, those crippled kids. We find out that Towely has, like, a whole-ass family. Like, he has a wife. And they have a baby together named Washcloth.
Oh, that's so... Oh, my God. Wow.
But then Towely, you know, Towely's likes getting high, so his wife like kicks him out. His wife's a human, by the way.
Wait, what?
His wife's a human.
She's not a towel?
No. No. But Washcloth is a washcloth.
How exactly does he have a child with this lady?
He's genetically altered.
He has a penis?
I suppose so. I feel like he'd have to have a penis for them to have sex, unless they just scissored the whole time.
What
but
part?
You can't really scissor when you're a towel because, you know, rock, paper, scissors. So
what?
He probably has a penis.
This is a weird show, Dizzy.
It's my favorite show.
This is a weird show. Why is this your favorite show?
I don't know, I just like it.
Okay.
I've been watching it since I was a baby.
Do you have... Oh, that explains a lot about you, actually. Do you have any idea why teen girls seem so attracted to this show? There's like a disproportionate amount of teen girls.
I don't know if I'm allowed to say it on stream.
DM it to me and I'll say it on stream. Oh, because teen girls like little boys.
Yeah.
No, that's okay. That's okay.
I mean, have you met Rie?
I have.
She's canonically 17 forever, I think.
Oh, so it's not pedophilia. It's okay.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. Okay. But then why is it that it seems like... Okay, so this is... I'm not part of the South Park fandom. So maybe what I've seen of it is, like, skewed. But I feel like what I usually see from South Park fans is, like, the boys as, like, teenagers.
Yeah, well, because you can't really write porn of 10-year-old boys, you know?
Well, you could. Japan does it all the time.
Well, the Japanese do. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, if you've ever read Japanese South Park, Japan loves South Park.
Japanese South Park? That's a thing?
Yeah, Japan loves South Park. There's a lot of episodes that reference Japanese people. But Japan loves South Park. And if you've ever read South Park doujinshi that's straight from Japan?
No, I can't say I have, actually. Dizzy, have you?
Oh, I have some. I'll lend it.
You have some? Like, you have, like, physical copies?
Maybe.
Oh my god.
I can't say yes or no because it's very illegal in my country. My home and native land.
There's a lot of this creek stuff, Dizzy. Do you watch this stuff?
What the fuck is this?
Do you watch this?
No. But this one doesn't seem to be the worst.
That one's Kenny?
That one's Kenny, yeah.
And this is Kyle. And that one's Tweak. Yeah.
Yes.
What
the fuck is that?
I'm single. Wait, who are those two?
That was Clyde and the blonde girl. I'm forgetting her name. She's the hot girl of tits. Just sent you a tits, actually.
Oh, okay.
Baby, yeah, baby.
There's only so much of that I can handle. Okay. Wow, there's a lot of this.
I'm surprised you got as far as you did. I am surprised and shocked that you got as far as you did.
Oh, there's a Heather's version. Oh, this one looks good. This one looks good.
Why do I know exactly which one this is? This is not the one I was thinking of.
I was gonna hold that against you a little bit. Dick. I'd normally slap your face. Wait, it's their voices.
Oh, AI has come so far. And everyone here could watch. But I'm
feeling nice. Here's some advice. Listen up, biatch. It's their voices. What the fuck? Oh, he's not fat anymore.
First of all, Parker would never be a Heather. He's too fat.
True.
Yeah.
This is... Oh my god, there's so many thumbnails of them kissing.
Yeah. I used to follow the creek, like... hashtag on Twitter. Not proud of that.
It's not just nice images of creeks.
Yeah, I would just scroll it every day for serotonin.
Because you really like to look at streams?
I was in a bad place.
Oh my god. I don't know what I was expecting when I clicked Tunnel of Slurs.
Well, that was only like the third worst thing that we saw today.
Is this in the show, The Tunnel of Slurs?
Let's see, what's another like, iconic...
No! Tunnel of Slurs! Oh, The Tunnel of Prejudice.
So, fun fact, Kuwait, the country of Kuwait, or whatever...
Kuwait?
The country of Kuwait made a South Park knockoff.
Now hold on, we're looking at The Tunnel of Prejudice.
Queer! Boehner, chink, nigger, heave,
faggot,
cracker.
Oh man, this is
this was on television?
Now yeah. You know how it feels.
I want to ride again. Vaughn. I want to ride again.
It's my shot.
Anyway, so this is Block 13, the Kuwait knockoff of South Park. That's how I'm in the cargo. Walla.
Listen, if it was safe for television, it was safe for my stream. Alright, chat, shut the fuck up. What the fuck? Are they wearing religious clothing?
Yes! Cause this is Kuwait!
Ah! Oh my god, they even have their own Kenny.
Yeah, so now before anyone calls this racist, just know it was produced in Kuwait.
Yeah.
Bas baba, laisa wo girgir wazid wala.
What good religious family fun. Oh my god.
What good religious family fun.
Wow.
I believe it was also a... It might be a Canadian South Park thing. It was like called North Park or something. It was a set of shorts. But there's a lot of knockoff South Park content.
North Park. Do you have more of these?
Let me see if I can find it. That one might be a little harder to find. Let's see. North Park shorts.
There's like a show called North Park or something, but it's like by the Bob's Burgers people and it's about Alaska. North.
I'm wondering if it might be the same thing. Okay, I found it, but I'm not sure if I've actually never watched this. So if we watch this, we're watching this for the first time together.
Well, my stream already has the N-word and the F-slur in it, so can't get much worse.
What's a slur that I'm allowed to say on stream?
Any that belongs to your people, Dizzy. You are free to reclaim whatever applies to you.
Ching chong ling long ting tong?
South Park, Wednesday at 10.
That's the first thing I thought of.
I wish we could afford new jerseys.
Yeah, but where are we gonna come up with that kind of money?
Hey, look! I found a wallet! There's $1,000 in it!
Canadian South Park,
that's
boys.
Right, Jean-Luc. That's exactly what we're gonna do.
Hey, mister! We found your wallet!
Thanks, fellas.
Dude, what the hell is this disgusting crap?
There's only one South Park, and it's only on Much. Wednesday at 10.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it wasn't like an actual knockoff.
Maybe quite a few of these, though. There's quite a bit of North Park stuff.
Oh.
Yeah. Where's Terrence and Philip? Oh, yeah. So in the show, there's another show called Terrence and Philip that the boys like to watch. One of the weird things is Terrence and Philip are always aging. Like, I think canonically at this point, they're ancient. They are old as dirt. But the boys never age.
Terrence and Philip?
Yeah.
They sound like British royalty.
Oh, well, that's part of a joke, because, so Canada is still owned, like, technically British land, I guess?
Huh?
Something like that. I don't know. So, there's this whole British royal family in South Park, and they're basically, for better or worse, just the British.
Oh, ew. Ew, do you have any clips of them?
Yeah, let's see if I can find any. Canadian royal wedding.
It's a Commonwealth country? That sounds like a fancy name for communism. The Canadian royal family.
I mean, I feel like French Canadians are basically communists.
Mm. That explains a lot.
I don't know if that holds any water. I don't know anything about politics. I'm a fucking bug. But, that's the take I'm going with.
Care not, we're not looking at the border wall episode.
Winnipeg,
I feel like I know exactly what that would have in it. Nah.
So Canada's border wall.
Okay,
all the biggest Canadian
I did not
celebrities
know
are on
be
hand.
In it.
There are Sirs Terrence and Philip, with their wives, the lovely Queef sisters. I believe one of the sisters just queefed just now. And there he is, the Prince of Canada.
What a wonderful
day it is for him. What a wonderful day it is for all of us.
Wow, Canada's beautiful.
Inside the Abbey now, everyone waiting with anticipation.
It looks just like the pictures.
There's
the Queen of Canada
lines.
In attendance, of course. I believe she just quit. Prince makes his way down the aisle, led by the Bishop of Newfoundland.
It's a lady fart in their lady part.
Okay, I just want to make sure you're understanding the joke.
I'm aware, Dizzy.
Okay.
The Prince takes his place next to the large vat of butterscotch pudding. Oh, and here she comes. Yes, there she is.
It's one of the Canadian national foods, I think.
The about to be Princess of Canada.
That and poutine.
Oh, okay.
Isn't she ravishing? So pure of heart, so strong in body, so hot in the face. She is indeed the living symbol of our great country. My God, she's beautiful.
Princess.
Aww.
Canadian Prince now dipping his arms into the pudding, as is tradition. Princess will, of course, scrape the pudding off the Princess's arms, thus symbolizing their union. What a glorious day for our country and indeed the world.
And now, I guess one day I'll have a Canadian wedding.
Uh-oh, something is going terribly
wrong. They look beautiful.
The abbey's shaking violently as explosions abound.
Do you like pudding?
Yes, the top of the abbey is collapsing.
Yeah, I like pudding.
The prince and the princess look on in horror.
I'm a jello person myself.
This is not the tradition.
Ew, seriously?
This is not tradition at all.
Yeah, man.
Giant
like
hole
an
now
elite
blasted
dessert.
Into the ceiling. Debris falling
so
down
fun.
And crushing
colorful.
Several spectators.
Jello?
Which is also not the tradition
yeah.
for a royal Canadian wedding.
Pudding is so much better.
Right. Beam of light shooting through the hole in the ceiling.
You ever get those, like,
is pudding,
princess
is pudding
now
colorful?
In some kind of
it can be.
Cube.
I've gotten colorful pudding.
Certainly
they had unicorn pudding.
Now.
No.
Was it good?
Yeah. No.
Canadians in attendance cannot believe their eyes. Why
I was gonna lie
hand?
To you at first, but I couldn't even pretend.
The princess being
that's what I
hoisted
thought.
Away. The little mushroom people
no,
of Nova
Canadian
Scotia
wedding.
Screaming
Canadian
with horror.
Wedding.
Oh, no.
The prince is attempting to grab
what
hold
is happening?
Of the cube. This is indeed a horrible day for all of Canada, and therefore, and the pudding
they've
has just been knocked
princess.
Over. Oh, this does not go with tradition at all. The royal pudding now spilling all over the abbey.
Oh, no, the
as
pudding.
The princess is lifted up, up.
Oh, the pudding.
Oh, no.
Pudding.
And she's gone. The princess has been taken.
Oh, no.
This
where'd
is indeed
go?
A horrible day for Canada, and therefore, the rest of the world.
She's gone. She's gone.
Forever?
I think she comes back.
Oh, no. The crying child is so cute.
Yeah. Have you ever kicked the baby?
No. I can't say I have. Sounds like you have another clip in mind.
Yeah. So, they don't do this to him anymore. But Ike was initially just introduced for, like, this one gag, which was kick the baby.
Oh, sweet. Yeah, check it out. Ready, Ike? Kick the baby!
Don't kick the goddamn baby.
Kick the baby!
Oh no! Oh no!
Yeah, we've been doing this since the first episode.
Is, all right. Ow. Dude, that kicks ass! Yeah, check this one out. Ready, Ike? Kick the baby!
Don't kick the baby.
Kick the baby!
What the fuck?
Yeah, I think they probably took it out because people were probably kicking babies.
Probably. Like how they were harassing gingers. I wonder if we can find, like, footage, like, home footage of somebody actually, like, kicking a ginger person in the name of South Park. Bullying gingers for
it's
South Park.
It's literally, literally the first search result. Let's watch this video.
Police are investigating a series of bizarre and disturbing attacks that have left children in cities from coast to coast injured and fearing for their safety.
Mm-hmm.
As Global's Anna Gebauer tells us, the young victims were targeted simply because of the color of their hair.
My speech is entitled Ginger Kids, Children with Red Hair, Light Skin, and Freckles.
From the lips of
she
South Park's little Eric Cartman on television, talking about his dislike of redheads, an idea was planted and took root on internet sites logged onto by kids all across Canada.
I came to school.
Yes.
And after my first class, I was repeatedly kicked by different people.
13-year-old Aaron Mishkin says he was kicked about 80 times
depression.
At school on Thursday, which had been dubbed Kick a Ginger Day on a number of internet sites. 2 days later, Aaron's legs are still bruised. And he's amazed so many of his peers joined in.
Kick a Ginger Day was used as an excuse to do violence on other people and to hurt them for your own enjoyment.
Wow,
from
he's really kickable.
There were warnings by parents, teachers, and schools
I mean,
to guard
ginger.
Against Kick a Ginger Day.
You know what? I don't even think it's because he's ginger. I think he's just really annoying. And the
at
other students
Calgary
wanted to kick him.
Student suspensions. A 12-year-old girl in tears after being taunted about her
I like
red
how they
hair.
Censor her out
at another
just
school.
Like these two
possible
flowers.
Yeah, what the fuck?
After the kicking of a grade 10 boy.
We can blame Facebook or we can blame South Park, but in the end, it's choices that students make, and we try and instill in them how to make good choices and not choices that cause them difficulties.
We haven't developed
kind of a base
norms to counter this form of behavior, and we need to do more to counter these norms.
Morrison sees an opportunity for schools and parents to use this as a teaching tool.
RCMP in British Columbia are now investigating the 14-year-old administrator of the Facebook site called National Kick a Ginger Day.
The Facebook
site!
Site
had nearly 5,000 members from across Canada and the world. And now that young teen could be facing hate crime-related charges.
What?
Robin, Anna Gabala in Vancouver, thanks.
What is Canada done? Hate crime charges? No.
It's okay. They dropped the charges. I never got in trouble for anything.
Oh, that's... Oh, I'm happy for you, Dizzy.
Thank I'm happy for me too.
Oh my god, hate crime charges. Hate crime charges. Okay, hot take here. But, and it has nothing to do with hate crimes, but wouldn't, like, as, like, a parent or, like, a teacher, mm-hmm. wouldn't you rather the students be, like, targeting ginger kids because of, like, South Park and stuff? Because then, like, their attention is focused on that, and you can kind of, like, nip it in the bud, right? Because it's easier to be like, here's, okay, you're kicking and attacking the ginger kids because of South Park. Here's actually, like, why that's bad and stuff. And, like, there's, like, ways that you can handle it and, like, control that behavior.
Okay, tell me why it's bad, Pippa. Try to teach me why kicking ginger is bad.
Okay, well, I'm not, like, a fucking teacher or some shit, okay? I have no issue with kicking ginger people. I'm just saying, like, as, like, a teacher or, like, a parent, right? It's like, when you can identify the cause of the behavior, it's a lot easier to deal with than, like, if you don't know, right? Like, with like, schools, when children are just bullying each other, right? What are you gonna do? You're gonna be like, oh, bullying is bad. Right? But when you know that it's, like, because of South Park, it's, like, you're able to identify what it is, and you can kind of, like, reshape their minds to, like, focus on... You can kind of, like, redirect them, right?
I don't know. There's been, like, quite a few times where, like, parents or schools have, like, spoken up against South Park. This show has a way of making people very angry.
I wonder why.
It's never worked.
It's never worked out. You mean except for that time that those people managed to get their deities and stuff censored?
Yeah.
Sounds like it worked those times.
They were just showed. Like, I think they have showed Muhammad on... Yeah, they have showed Muhammad on the show, so...
Mm.
It's only a temporary thing.
Mm.
As is most censorship, I feel.
Mm. You just gotta keep pushing through it.
Yeah.
You know, chat, you know, I'm not like accusing them of anything. I'm just saying. Let's see here. Oh my god, wait, there's like more videos. There's more videos on like
of Kick a Ginger Day?
Yeah, hold on. I want like Kick a Ginger Day. Oh, death? Wait, did somebody die from this? No, nobody died from this. Why does it say death? Why are gingers so desperate to be oppressed? Hold on. What is this? National Kick a Ginger Day PSA. This was uploaded 8 months ago.
Oh, this has to be some fan content.
I'm a comedian.
I'm a creator.
I'm a student.
I'm a woman.
But I'm also a ginger.
But I'm also a ginger.
A ginger.
A ginger.
No, this is not funny. This is not funny at all.
Today is National Kick a Ginger Day.
A sickening and outdated celebration.
And that does nothing but promote harmful stereotypes and ostracize members of our red-haired community.
Yeah, so we may be freckled.
What would you find funny? What sort of comedy do you like, Peppa?
No, hold on. I want to find this comedian's channel, and I want to bring up his comedy skits, and I want to laugh at how stupid he is.
Okay, let's do it. We're already here.
Yeah, I want to bully a ginger person. Okay, let's see here. Let's see here. Is this his channel? I can't tell. Alright. I think this might be him.
Hey.
Is that the guy who claimed he was a comedian?
This is where I sit. This is where I study. And this is where the magic happens.
He looks like he has weak genetics.
He does.
Alan Poe watches me. This is my
bird.
He looks
Canadian.
His name is Flicky. Flicky no longer chirps.
He looks like the unfun parts of Florida.
Yeah. Ooh, got me.
Look at this. Oh, hey.
Why does this get
and
funny?
Look at this little guy.
I don't know.
He's my cactus, and he watches the Dunkin' Donuts.
Wow.
So there it is.
Oh, that's a halal guy. He's worse than
aren't you glad I didn't
a Canadian.
Say banana?
He's from New York.
Ooh.
Please, if you're seeing this, somebody let me out of the bathroom.
This man claims to be a comedian, chat. What say you?
Do you? Well,
what say
you,
chat?
There's a few rules you need to establish before you do. In the evenings, would
New York comedy?
Not too much. Not too
this
little.
This has got to be an expensive place, though.
Just enough.
If he's in New York.
called trust funds.
What?
Yeah.
I won't.
That explains why he never developed a personality.
Most gingers don't. They're incapable of it. They don't have souls.
Ah, that's true. That checks out. Do you have more clips?
Let's see. What do you think is funny? Like, I'm trying
bullying
to, like,
gingers.
Bullying gingers.
Yeah.
Yeah,
this just proves why gingers need to be bullied. It does.
Ninjas, South Park. Let's watch with ninjas.
The ninjas?
Yeah. Yeah. Let's watch a ninja episode.
Ninjas? I'm curious. Is this going to be more attacking Japanese people?
Oh, if you want something attacking Japanese, I got you. But let's watch this first.
Okay.
They actually keep
guys meeting over
the
here,
scar on Butter's eyes, and you see it later when he's an adult.
They come,
really?
Do the right thing.
Yeah. It's canonical. Like, they keep this. This is,
dude,
they,
shut up.
They keep
I
all
agree
of
with
it.
Carmen. What? You don't understand what my mom would
I think
do
it's actually half blind
after this.
But yeah.
Wait, when does he become like an adult? Oh, there's the game trailer. Snow Day?
Yeah, that's the game trailer, unfortunately. Do you want to see it?
Sure. When do they become adults? Is there like a flash forward into the future?
Yeah, let's look at that actually. I was gonna show you something else, but...
Oh, okay. I'm sorry, Miss South Park Mega Fan. I'm sorry, I'm impeding on your content list. COVID?
This is gonna... Yeah, so I think I told you about what happens to Butters. He becomes,
Hi, Reyna!
Some NFTs!
If you just believe in NFTs, then I believe in NFTs, and then they believe in NFTs, and we make all kinds of fucking money!
That's a pretty goddamn good idea.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
Were there not South Park NFTs?
No, I think, Matt and Trey are actually quite against NFTs, so...
I feel like there was some, like,
they do have a gacha game.
Ooh. There's a gacha game?
It's a card game. It's on the phone. I think it's still live, but,
Oh my god, did you pull for Craig and Tweak?
I never actually rolled on the game, because I don't gamble like that.
Oh.
Surprisingly. Of all the things that I refused to do, it was gambling.
But how are you going to make their cards sit next to each other in the deck if you don't have them both? Dizzy.
It's okay. I'll just support them by wasting money on physical merch that I can actually own and enjoy.
You're buying all of that from, like, Amazon sellers, which are based in China.
No, I buy it from the official website like a fucking idiot.
Hey.
Really?
Microsoft.
Wait, no.
Yeah.
No, Dizzy, you have to show me the official merch page. Send me the link. Send me the fucking link. I need to see exactly what you're buying here, Dizzy.
Well, it's limited drops. I don't even know if they'll have everything, but there was, there's been t-shirts, there was towel, there was stuffies.
Oh my god, stuffies?
Yeah, they have stuffed animals. Well, not stuffed animals, stuffed characters.
Hold
dolls.
Let me just click on this stuff, make sure it's safe.
Yeah, I think it's the main website, can't be that bad.
Okay. Boom.
Boom.
Oh my god, do you have one of these? Do you have one of these character hoodies? The color black ones?
No, but I have one of the hats somewhere.
One of the hats? One of the character hats?
I think I have a Kenny hat somewhere.
You wear a little Kenny hat!
Yeah, I have a little Kenny hat.
It's like, it's shaped like Kenny!
It's just his color scheme, okay?
It's just his color scheme!
Kenny doesn't even have a hat. He's the only one without a hat canonically because he's poor.
Oh, he's poor. He has to wear a hood.
Yeah.
Oh, well, you're also poor, so you should get the Kenny hood, and then you can put your hood up and you can be poor and sad like
because
Kenny.
Because I'm a VTuber. I'm having a real job.
He's enough. Oh my god, shut up.
Oh, listen, man. I respect the hustle.
There's
did we get cut?
No, for like a second. We're back.
Okay.
My internet's dog shit. You just learn to live with it.
Yeah, I see your ping.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They don't have any plushies right now.
Very unfortunate.
Very unfortunate. Like, they have like a bunch of... Oh my god, wait, you can buy the towel?
You can buy the towel. You can buy Towelie.
Towelie, the beach towel!
Are you considering buying Towelie?
No.
Oh.
No. No, I'm not. Oh wait, hold on, hats. Oh, God, Dizzy, tell me it's the South Park Kenny cosplay hooded hat with fur.
It's not. It's not, I promise.
It's not!
It's not!
No, Dizzy! Dizzy, no!
Yeah, I'm sorry.
You should get that one.
I'm sorry.
You should get that one.
Yeah, I'll make it a Dono Go or something. I'll have a Donathon specifically for South Park merch.
You should do that. Do it.
Yeah. That will definitely improve my quality of life.
Oh my god, South Park Cornhole. Oh my god. A fucking D20 for some reason. Okay. A puzzle?
Well, the whole Rubik's thing about Cube? Stick of Truth... The Stick of Truth is incredibly, like, you know, D&D-themed. Well, it's a Game of Thrones. How Stick of Truth happened is, like, Game of Thrones was really popular at the time.
Uh-huh.
But because it's fantasy, you can basically apply it to all, like, popular... all popular fantasy franchises, like Game of Thrones, Lord of the Rings, D&D...
Dizzy, I found your new outfit. Your next outfit, Dizzy.
All right, chat. If everyone can help support me to get to the next milestone so I can get a second outfit, that'd be great.
It's only $47, Dizzy.
Only $47?
It's only $47. Look at it, Dizzy. Look at that. Look at that.
Amazing. Incredible.
Would you wear this?
Yeah, 100%.
Hey, what the fuck? Monday, thank you for the $50. I love you, Dizzy. Awesome VTuber. What? You donated to me, asshole.
Yeah, I was about to say. I don't think you know how this money thing works.
Fuck you. Oh, they have a Halloween collection.
Thanks for supporting Pippa Pipkin. P-P-P-P-P, you bitch.
Oh, don't do first name, last name. I know it's Western style, but it's cringe. It doesn't sound right.
Pippa Pipkin?
Pippa Pipkin. It sounds wrong.
It literally just sounds like Pipkin Pippa.
No, it doesn't. Pipkin Pippa rolls off the tongue. It sounds more natural.
Pippa Pipkin.
No. No. This shirt is just Randy's face, but only on the front.
Yeah.
Okay.
We should start doing merch like this for FaZe, you know? We should. Put your face on a t-shirt, like, really blown up.
We should. Actually, some of these merch designs are very cool. I wish we had cool merch like this.
Hey, chat. If you didn't know already, FaZe Connect has a new Twitter where you can learn more about our merch releases as well as get updates on merch shipments. Go there right now. Go to that new Twitter and at them and tell them that you want a t-shirt that just has Pipkin Pippa's face very blown up on it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and you can also find out about, like, shipping updates there. You can go there, and they'll be like, oh, still hasn't shipped, sorry. And then you'll check back a few months later, and they'll be like, oh, still hasn't shipped, sorry. And then you'll check back a few months after that, and it'll say!
And then eventually, everyone else will have gotten their merch before you, so you're gonna have to start a claim on the FaZe Connect server to get your merch shipped out. Which will just be Sakuna going to the warehouse in the middle of the day going, oh shit, we forgot to ship this out, and then shipping out your merch for you finally.
Yeah. Hey, yeah. That means our CEO's hands will have touched your merch. You should be honored.
Exactly. And hey, by the way, if you want actual good Pipkin Pippa merch, I recommend you check out her new t-shirt collab with Anime Bay.
Yeah!
Is that Anime Bay?
Yeah, Anime Bay. Like
how many t-shirts are there?
Like a few.
See, I don't need to. I don't really need to show your merch ever. So like, I'm not good at this stuff.
I don't have a thing for that, but I have a thing for Yumacon. Woo! Yumacon! There'll be merch there.
What are you doing for Yumacon? Did Gen 1 decide yet?
Funny story about that, right? So Gen 1, we're doing a game show, right?
Oh, yeah? Yeah.
But we haven't been able to decide on what we're doing for the game show. So management DMs me and they're like, can you get the title from Gen 1 for the game show so we can send it to Yumacon? And I was like, okay. And then I went into the Gen 1 Discord and I said, hey, here are some ideas. But in the meantime, what if we just call it like... FaZe Gen 1 VTuber Interactive Adventure.
Oh, no. That's what they went with, isn't it?
Yeah, and we have no idea what we're doing. We just came up with a title just to shut them up.
It'll be an ARG, guys. It'll be a really exciting and fun to play ARG. That will take you on a real interactive adventure. That's definitely where that's going. This is going to be a very high-effort production, surely.
Nondescript adventures, yeah!
It's okay. They did the same thing to Invaders. But one thing about Invaders is if they can make me do their work, they will make me do their work for them.
What'd you do?
I don't know. I wrote like 3 different descriptions and 3 different titles and submitted all of them and told management to pick. So we don't actually know what we're doing.
Oh my God. That was like one of my suggestions for Gen 1. I was like, listen, if we can't come to a consensus, we'll just send management all these ideas and they can just pick.
Does anyone in chat know what I'm doing at Yomacon? Let me know.
That's so fucked up.
I was gonna ask if they had extra slots because I was thinking we could do a Yabcast with Lumi or something.
Wait, you should do that. The deadline is today, isn't it?
I don't know. They rushed me. My deadline was like 2 days ago.
Oh, are you serious?
Yeah.
No. You don't have these cool Gen 1 privileges where we get to turn our stuff in 2 days late. Don't touch me!
Senpai. Oh, Pippa Day Senpai, thank you so much for carrying the company on your back.
You're welcome.
For your entire career.
You're welcome. I didn't say anything about that. I think that's your projection coming through. There you go. You can see my DM with management. Can I request another panel slot for... I'm just gonna sign Lumi up for this.
Yeah. She'll show up.
For me. Dizzy.
Here's my concept, everyone. Here's my concept. You guys are gonna like this, okay? Yabcast Thanksgiving special.
Yeah. Even though Yomacon's the first week of November. You mean just in general?
When's Thanksgiving?
Thanksgiving's like the 25th or something? 24th?
It's close enough. Same month.
Yeah! Oh my god. Manager responded immediately. Yeah. Oh my god. She said for Yomacon? Question mark?
Yes.
Wow. Oh my god. We're pulling the strings. We're making it happen.
Oh my god, are we actually making it happen?
We might make this happen. This is a historic moment. Why do collabs and stuff and projects... Oh, yeah, I can definitely ask them for you. No promises, though. Oh my god. Thank you. I really appreciate it.
Thank you, management.
Management love. People happy. There we go. Oh my god. Wow. Nepotism live on stream. Hell yeah. Yeah, wait. Is Yomacon gonna be okay with Yabs? What's like the limit of what we can say at Yomacon?
I mean, I figure as long as we fill the room, they don't really care, right?
Yeah, probably. They let like hentai panels and shit happen, probably, so it's fine.
Yeah, worst case, just put us at midnight. I'm sure there'll be enough people to fill the room.
Yeah. Oh, wait. Oh, should we specify that? That it would be an 18 plus panel?
No. If your kid goes to a Phase Connect panel, that's on you as a parent.
I think we might need to specify, Dizzy, unironically.
No.
Okay.
No.
All right. Oh, it's Detroit, so it's fine. That's true. The standard's already very low there. Okay. Adventures of Princess Kenny. We were watching this?
Yeah, I suppose we were.
Okay.
この Black Friday すぐ来る。これが問題ですね。今、プリンセスキーにすごい入ります。
ただいま。ただいま。プリンセスキーにレポート。
あ、行きました。かわいいな、プリンセスキーに。うん、早いで。プリンセスキーにありがとう。問題だよ。Xbox 最初のビールケース、私の PS4 シップメント止まっています。
はい、プリンセスキーにアシスト。
So,
Baka!
からは疎開地点です。
あら、プリンセスキーニー。
みんな、キーニー来ます。
大変。この乾燥ウォーズまだ終わらない。
そうです。
うん。
Xbox とソニー PS4 ネックアンドネックです。
みなさんいいか。プリンセスキーニー頑張る。
キーニーちゃん、失礼ですけど。ウェディングインビテーション来ました。
え、ウェディング、
ケニーちゃん、 please come home at once.
What the fuck?
Did you ever watch Game of Thrones?
Come to the Red Robin wedding. No, I did not.
All accept you.
Okay, so there's like red wedding thing where a bunch of people die. So that's why this is a Red Robin wedding. That's a reference.
Oh,
yeah.
Princess Kini, 本当に全部ありがとう。
気をつけて、キニちゃん。
Translate for us, Pippa.
さようなら。
They're saying thank you and goodbye.
みなさん、さようなら。
Your Japanese is really getting good, Pippa. Oh my god.
Thank you, thank you. Yeah.
That's impressive.
Oh.
え？なんてこと？
Why?
キニ殺した。本当。
She's dead.
It's okay. Kenny's superpower is coming back to life. Also notice that even get alien character reference in background.
Cute.
Yeah.
What the fuck? What the fuck?
I love Princess Kenny.
Is this the only Princess Kenny clip?
There's some really good scenes in the game, but I don't want to spoil that for
you. Yeah, no,
so basically how one of the things that led to like the boys having a fight in the game is Kenny really wanted to dress up like a girl.
Yeah, there's like the confusion at the beginning as to why Kenny is dressed up like a girl.
He just wants to feel pretty, man.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Do the teenage girls Stan and headcanon Kenny as trans?
You know, I'm sure a couple of them do.
I'm not hating, I'm just curious. I'm just curious. Oh my god, another, oh my god. We can request another panel. Oh, we would need program title name. Okay, we'll just call it Yabcast?
Yabcast Thanksgiving special.
Yabcast Thanksgiving. Okay.
You're welcome, chat. You're welcome for the extra content that only a small selection of you will be privy to.
Nah, people will record it and shit. Maybe it'll be streamed. I don't know.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Okay, wait, for the write-up, we need, like, information, right? Like, Pippa, Dizzy, and Lumi all talk about the, what are we talking about? For Yabcast?
Do we have topics for Yabcast? I don't know how Yabcast works.
Yeah, Lumi and I don't either. That's why we haven't started it yet. Ooh, okay, how about like the history of Thanksgiving?
Do you know how long this project has been in the like pipeline for?
Okay, listen. They don't know, but also in Lumi and I's defense, we tried to come up with a date for it, and then management was like, no, your assets aren't done yet. And it was like, what? How are we supposed to come up with stuff anyway? Like, we could have prepped content ahead of time, but now the assets are done. They got done like 2 weeks ago, so no excuse anymore. But
yeah. You absolutely could. I thought we were doing Yabcast pre-recorded for the most part. That was the original plan when I was working on it.
Yeah, I think it's gonna be like live stream now. What assets? Yeah, assets, chat. There's like a bunch of custom assets for it.
Well, good luck to Pippa and Lumi, who will be the host of Yabcast.
I don't like how sarcastic you're being. Okay, we need to hold on. What? Talk about the history.
Holidays. Let's talk about the holidays. Thanksgiving.
History of the holidays.
There's a lot of Yab things we can say about Thanksgiving.
True, and only half of them have to do with racism. History of Thanksgiving.
It's okay. They don't know what I am. I can get a pass.
I don't think your sort was necessarily involved in the Thanksgiving stuff. I think that was a different group of people, actually. I'm just saying.
Remember, history is written by the ones who win it.
Are you saying your people were also oppressed and didn't win the oppression Olympics or something? Is that what you're saying? Are you making this oppression competition now?
We could totally do that for Yapcast.
We probably shouldn't.
Aww.
I'm gonna go out on a limb. To say, oh, Pippa doesn't know about World War II. I'm gonna blow your fucking mind, but World War II didn't happen during Thanksgiving. That has nothing to do with Thanksgiving, okay? Jesus Christ. Do you have any- okay, I'll add it in with the rest of- Oh my god, we're making this happen. Oh, should I message Lumi and tell her?
Yeah, just at her. You don't even need to, like, message her privately. Just at her and you know what? I'll do it. Because this is my thing during stream. I like to just at Lumi. We're doing a bonus panel for Yomacon. You can't say no.
Oh, that works. Oh, World War II ran through Thanksgiving. Okay. But it doesn't have to do with the inception of Thanksgiving, and it's not a notable Thanksgiving-related event, okay?
Should we end the stream there? Should we end it on a good note? Congratulations, chat. You're getting bonus content.
Oh,
it's
sure.
It's happening.
You all burnt out? You sufficiently yabbed out for tonight?
I mean, I could get worse if you want me to.
Yeah, get worse. Do it.
Chat!
Get off my channel, Dizzy. We already hit the slurs threshold, okay? No more. No more, Dizzy. Dizzy, would you like to shill yourself? I said shill, by the way, not kill. Don't get excited.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh. Hey, if you liked my content, go and check out my channel at Dizzy Dokerel. I do fuck all.
Oh, hold on. Let's bring up your content on screen.
But Sakuna doesn't watch me, so I can go much worse than Pippa can.
It's true.
How does it feel being monitored?
I don't like it. I don't like it.
Also, I laugh like a Pillsbury Doughboy, if you guys are into that. I guess.
It's cute. It's delightfully quirky. Oh my god. Mother Mold debut. Hey, I'm noticing some pink rabbit hairs here. Ears?
Yeah.
Fuck, that was a tongue twister. Is that some, fucking copyright infringement?
Like I don't infringe on copyrights every other stream.
True. Oh my god, there's your collab with Lumi?
Yeah, and hey, if you like my collaboration with Pippa, check out my birthday stream, or check out the stream where I sell her ears for dirt cheap.
Wait, which stream was that?
Don't worry about it, Pippa.
What stream was that? Dizzy? Dizzy?
Yeah.
What stream was that?
What? What? Did you know there's a... Did you know about, you can grow meat in labs now?
That's crazy. Oh, fucking loud.
Yeah. That's an easy thing to brush away. Goodbye.
It's somewhere in there. Don't worry about it.
709. D10. Thank you for a super chat. Arclight, thank you for a super chat.
No, I skipped right to where you were reading super chats. So do you want to explain, Dizzy? Do you want to explain what's going on here?
In this stream, I'm cleaning the basement.
You're cleaning? This is the official Face Connect basement?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
And what's this? What's this, Dizzy?
I'm Sakuna's hopes and dreams.
True. So anyway, that
he
was-
He doesn't need those anymore.
He doesn't. It's so fucking over for him. Did you see when he messaged NASA?
Yeah.
He fucking messaged NASA.
Apparently, Face Connect Yab has transcended language barriers.
It's so sad.
Anyways, subscribe to my channel for whatever reason, by Pippa Pipkin.
Don't call me that!
Pipkin Pippa's, by Pipkin Pippa's.
Take it.
T-shirts and coffee, and
is your birthday merch still on sale?
No, it's done. Oh. It's done. Yeah, it's okay. Done. And okay. send aggravated tweets towards our staff about how you want even more tackly designed apparel.
You can't say that about sponsorship clothing, Dizzy.
No. I mean, the South Park merch, oh, okay. But with us.
Okay.
With us. I love the sponsorship apparel.
Same.
I would never speak poorly about our sponsors.
Yeah, never.
Please sponsor me next.
Yeah.
It's not like I need the income or anything.
You're poor. Laugh like the Pillsbury Doughboy, whore. It just doesn't hit right. It doesn't hit the same when you're not actually laughing. I'd rather see you crying. Okay, never mind. Stop that. I don't want to see that either. Okay. Thank you, Dizzy.
Did you have fun? Did you have fun, Pippa?
I did. This was a weird stream.
I was gonna ask if you wanted to do, well, while we're still planning stuff out, I was gonna ask if you wanted to do it.
While you're on the spot!
Yeah, while you're completely on the spot, in front of thousands of viewers who are gonna put pressure on you to perform, I was gonna ask if you wanted to be on one of my out-of-character streams.
Oh, sure, I'm kind of always out of character, but hell yeah.
Well, we'll talk about, like, meta and stuff. I don't know if you're allowed. Do you have a gag order?
Do I have a gag order on, like, talking about, like, past life stuff?
Not that stuff. On, like, meta. On, like, what you do with your channel and stuff.
I have not consulted management about any of that in years, and I have talked about a lot of meta stuff. So, if there is, I don't know.
It's
I didn't
fun.
Read my contract.
My streams.
Yeah!
Anyways! Thank you for having me, Pippa.
Thank you for coming on.
I love you, Pippa.
I love you too.
As long as you behave. Stream usually. What? How do you usually end streams?
I just say, oh, it's a cringe. You can just like leave call. I'm gonna catch up on super chats.
Okay. Oh, it's a cringe,
and now
I guess.
It's gonna be awkward. Now it's gonna be awkward because you don't know how to leave call. And then your model's still gonna be on screen, even though your voice isn't
honestly,
gonna be on screen, and you're gonna have to figure
it
out.
Even,
your only option's
is
unplugging your router.
Is. I can't even find my Discord.
You can't. Well, I guess you're stuck here then.
Can you start reading super chats?
Sure. Yeah. Mods! Super chat list mods! Ding 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 mods!
You need your mods to get your super chat list?
Yeah, because there's just so many of them, you know?
Oh! What's it like being rich? What's it like being part of the 1%?
Oh, you know, it feels pretty good. I know you wouldn't know, but...
Pipkin Pippa is taking our gerbs. She's taking our gerbs from the working class.
Yeah, that's kind of like, ironic coming from an invader, a literal phase invader. Phase illegals.
Okay, you have me there.
Yeah, threw that right back at you.
There.
Oh, look at this super chat list. You don't know what this looks like, do you?
I don't even know what a mod is. I don't even know what a mod looks like.
Do you not have any mods?
I prefer it that way.
There you guys go. Chat, you can go be racist in her chat. There's no one there to stop you.
Well, Sakon has been asking me to, like, go recruit mods or whatnot, but, like, it just sounds like a pain. And my chats are very well-behaved.
I don't believe you.
Yeah, what's it like not having a well-behaved chat, Pippa?
I don't know. I don't know. My chat is also very well-behaved. They never say anything bad, ever. I've never
God
once...
damn it, she was media-trained.
Yep. Definitely never say anything bad.
Yeah, never.
So
disclaimer, we love our moderator team.
Yeah. You don't have one, so you're being sarcastic, but I appreciate my Jannies.
Technically, I have the two that everyone shares.
Oh.
Yeah.
Are they ever in your chat?
No.
Ha! Not even the face Jannies wants you! Sorry, that was too far. Sometimes I click onto your streams and I let them play in the background while I do other things.
Oh, that's pretty cringe. That's pretty cringe.
What do you mean that's pretty cringe?
Friend, that's pretty cringe.
Oh, no, you're pretty cringe. You're pretty cringe.
Yeah, that's kind of the whole shtick.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you're good at it.
I found my Discord!
Nice!
Can we please get some super chat reading so I can leave during an awkward moment?
During an awkward... You want an awkward moment? Okay, hi, Dizzy.
Yeah.
Hi, Dizzy.
Hey.
Hi, Dizzy.
Hey, Pippa.
Hi, Dizzy.
What's up?
Hi, Dizzy. The super chats are on your face. Hi, Dizzy.
Are they actually?
Yeah, I gotta move that. Hold on. Oh, not that source. Oh, now it's off screen, so I can't tell. Hi, Dizzy.
Hey.
Hi, Dizzy.
Hey.
Hi, Dizzy.
Hey.
Hi, Dizzy.
Hey.
Hi, Dizzy. Hi, Dizzy. Nope, she's gone. I'm not good with goodbyes. I miss her. I miss her. Now I'm just gonna stand in this black void. It's just me and you, chat. Alright. I'm still in the collab channel. Everybody in Phase Connect can see my fucking collab thing. That's not good. There we go. There we go. Okay. I was like scrolling through DMs and stuff. Oh, God. I miss her, bros. Anyways, if you guys like Dizzy, you guys can find her very easily by just clicking the link in the YouTube title. In my YouTube title, if you click the part that says Dizzy Dokuro, you can just click that and it takes you directly to her channel. And if you hit the subscribe button, you'll be notified of when she goes live. Stripe feeding, come big pee pee. Now I need music. This bot isn't going to make it, is it, Captain? It's fine. It's fine. Everything's fine. It isn't linked there? I think the link isn't working. The link in the YouTube... What? Why does it say all my stuff is... Hold on. Angry backspacing! VOD's dead? No! Sure, there were racial slurs, but they were racial slurs from a cartoon, so it's fine. Oh, lag. Whatever, I'll raid her shit at the end, so you can just go subscribe to her there. You can just... Holy shit, 10,000 votes. You guys really like South Park. Alright, I'm gonna catch up on Super Chats. South Park. Music. Instrumental. Is there a song that isn't 30 seconds from South Park? That I can play? South Park instrumental 1 hour loop. Okay, that's fine. Okay. Oh, that's loud. That's very loud. Oh my god. That's... I'll turn that down. Nice! Okay! So it's a good thing with the $2. Oh, hi, Ted! I hope y'all had a decent day! Yep, I'll sing the door. So domestic violence is now how we top the possum. Is there anything where the pee-pee? I didn't abuse Dizzy today. I genuinely, you know, like, I sat down and I learned. I learned from her. She taught me things. Is there anything with the gift pee-pee? That's just awesome. Thing with the $3.50, $3.50. Bill Witch Doctor, thing with the $5. Fun fact, the Canadian princess... Oh, okay, I don't read that. You abused her a little. The abuse comes later. So here, I think with $2, Dizzy wants to fuck us, let's go! The Moose Nugget, thank you for the $10, love your content, you've quickly become one of my favorite streamers! In defense of Colorist, his design isn't bad, he almost looks like a nerdier Albert Wesker from Resident Evil! Oh my god, I go to turn up the music a little bit and it starts blasting. Fujo Secret Knowledge! This song was made by the band Primus, if you're familiar with them. I sound familiar. Hey, did we do the thing with the 420? Glad the possum didn't give you rabies! Grin! Yuffles, thinking with $2, domestic violence, oh, mutiny meow, thinking with $2, cucking colorist, what the fuck, Pippa? Goodbye, thinking $5, Dizzy burying the lead to that theme, South Park was done by the legendary band Primus. Teddy's from Rugby, thinking with $2, something funny. Jacob Anderson, thinking with $2, something funny. Seth's cutting with the $2, something funny, you are not. Love America Hopper, thinking with $2, seeing Dizzy beaten, unbeaten is angering me. He must have been very, very angry at the stream. Isn't this copyrighted? Good question, I have no idea. I saw everything went to 5,000 clip arts. Pippa, you're a continuous source of inspiration. Thank you. didn't think I'm gonna be Dizzy didn't teach Pippa about imagination then. Sad. I know the South Park fans in chat were just sitting there foaming at the mouth. Nah, why didn't she talk about this? Lucy and thing with $2, Dizzy blink if you need help. Alexander thing with $2, Hector Gomez thing with $2, Dizzy said same thing, I'm foul. BK Slush thing with the 1337. While you're looking at stuff on Canadians, you should check out the Great Canadian Maple Syrup Heist of 2011. Isn't that an internet historian bid? The Rose thing with $5, happy 4th birthday, Pippa. What did Dizzy get you? Pepper Owl thing with $2, Carmen actually did gay stuff to Butters. Okay. Yuffle Zinger with $2, Goth and Emo Kids are the ones struggle against the vamps. See, that thing with $10, let's not talk about my racist past, let's talk about my racist future. Pipkin Pippa, no. Andrew Martinez Zinger with $100, Pippa collab with Dizzy, this one is for the books. Only the Spike Man thing with the 10 could be bad. Send Gunman thing with $5, as a hard thing with $2, Pippa no point if you are getting fed the answers. Well, I can't record a thing with 5 pippies. I wanted the answer, and then if I got the answer wrong after Dizzy corrected me, then that would mean she was wrong. So yeah. Follow Benedetti thing with $5. Dizzy is a fake fan. Onyx Jaguar thing $5. Consider a Cannibal the Musical watch along for your Trey Parker and Matt Stone reps. Eating Mike Tyson's ass thing with $5. Okay. Eating Mike Tyson's ass, thank you again for the $5. Beautiful song. Wilson Tending with $3.33. Classic South Park love. Arclight thing with the 5 pippies. And Gentarine Sink with $2 used this to fight my ancestors' nemesis, Mongo Range. Welcome Liang Ling, $2 cause it's funny. Zehutsume, thank you for the $2. Trey speaks Japanese, so that might explain it. Duffel, thank you for the $2 because if we accept that, then the Capellans win. What? Zentetsu, thank you for the 1,000 crocodiles. Can't accuse them of racism for doing the reverse. Tigrini, thank you for $2. We're sorry, Pippa. Maximus Genitalia, thank you for the $2. Is it just me or is Dizzy's breasts got bigger? They get bigger every time I look at them. And I look at them a lot. Sean Ramsey, thank you for the $2. We're sorry. Alex, thank you for the $5. Fake apology. No ukulele. David Hunt, thank you for the $2. A pipe failed. Snippers! I should have taken a clarinet! They do? You do what? Dad, I sniffle and it makes my head hurt. Snippers. Ah. I have this sparkling iced cherry limeade, and it tastes like somebody carbonated the flavoring for a popsicle. Baja, that thing with $2. This happened on my birthday. That day is quashed. Happy belated birthday! 18 Annihilator thing with $1. What a nice family meal. Nori eats a candy thing with 5,000 crocodiles. It was Radiohead's idea to have him eat his parents, by the way. They're interesting folks over at Radiohead. Kevin Acton thing with $2. Cardman is sleepy, a little scary with the plotting. I will read that in a second, birdie. Boomer Wilding with $5. Butters is aged down chorus. No, as a hard thing with $2. Butters just danced too hard. Oh, the Merkle Hopper thing with $2. Show Pippa the Woodland Critters Christmas. I think I've seen that. That's where the Woodland Critters kill everybody, right? Johari Awkward thinking where the $2 most of Butters' crimes are because of Cartman. The Hutsume thing with $5. Okay, I'm tired of this music. I lasted 5 minutes, chat, and now I'm done with the music. Meow! Thank you for the $5. Show her Cartman's hippie drill dizzy. That's amazing for the $5. The episode that reveals the twist with Scott Tenorman is 202/201, which can't be viewed legally outside of DVD releases due to the episode's censorship. Oh. Oh. And Tenorman thing for the $2. Turn up down a little bit. Yo! And then drain thing with $2. Have a -1 mil social credit band. Shut up. Milkman thing with $2. Butter shot several people in a dangle. DJ Robotnik thing with $2. SP fandom has the most toxic yaoi shippers ever. Jin Rose thing with $2. Butters also had a hand in the Kardashian deaths. Oh, okay. Eating Mike Tyson's ass thing with $5. How are you able to watch this on stream? Lol. It's simple. I do not care for consequences. Jin Rose thing with $2. Gingers have souls! Ryan thing with $5. As a ginger, I got kicked and told many ginger jokes after the ginger episode. Oh, that sucks. That you're ginger, I mean. Abeno Lazing with $2. Nicholas thing with $2. It was with the hard R. You need to say ginger. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, my bad. What's up, my ginger? Probilitator thing with $2. Play the remix. Gingers have soul. Bony Fairy and Minuet. Thank you for the $50. Please watch the 20 years of South Park song. 20 years of South Park. 20 years of South Park songs. Do I have to put it on screen or can I just listen to it? Comedy Central Asia. What the fuck? On screen? Hold on. Give me a second! Oh my god, the audio is different on every single window. Let me just stand right here. Fuck.
Oh my god, they killed Kitty!
Let me just... Fuck. Here we go. I cannot hear it. There we go.
20th anniversary every Wednesday.
That was not. There was not a lot to that. There was not. That was it. That was it. That was it. I moved out of the way and stuff for that. Motherfucker. Oh wait. No, there's a longer version.
Ernest came out of Carmen's butt. His mom was still a dirty slut. Cannon burst right into flame. And season four, so Satan's out of my Saddam Hussein.
20 years of self up, baby. 20 years of fun. 20 years of insults and the Carmen's slutty mom. 20 years of famous folk being rudely thrown. It's time for brand new self up. We're 20 years old. Scott's parents wound up in his dinner. We learned that AIDS are my gift this season. Crap people turn the whole town gay.
It's season 8, so
the
baddest of Mr. Slime.
We first up Garrison's vagina.
What?
Chef joined a call to prey on minor.
What?
They snuffed the snook up clean and sears.
What?
In season 12, so Randy's sitting drenched in his own jeers.
Oh, I've seen that, that's the image, that's even I've seen. I don't know why I thought it was a toilet. I guess because everything on the screen is white. Fair to think this show is older than some of the members of my audience. You'd enjoy South Park?
The police chief became a whore. Poor Randy's giant bolt grew so. Told us how poor way show so.
And in 16, Cartman admitted he was
fat as fuck.
George R. R. Martin showed his day. The cock magic was pretty slick.
But now it's time for season 20. Let's break out the code.
20 years of self pump, baby. 20
I'm spinning by those men. Trey made an awesome movie. Orgasmo? That sounds like porn.
Brand new self
pump on Comedy Central.
Okay. Okay, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. The 20th anniversary was 7 years ago. Oh my god. Oh my god. Wait, this shit is old. What the fuck? What the fuck? 27 years old. Holy shit. Old but gold? What season is it now? Probably like 27 or something. Holy shit. God damn. Zero Death X, thank you for the $2 that Ginger had rather soulless eyes. Just saying. Eclipse Nova, thank you. Delize Butters is forever be god tier character. Person with a Korean name I can't understand. Thank you for the 1,000 mods! Thank you, thank you. Should not applicable. Thank you, $2. Tell her about Lemmy Winch. Pick main. Thank you, $2. Opossum. Ex Mother Mold. Fanfic Win. The Pegasus Box. Thank you, $2. I shipped this collab so hard. Lore. Thank you for the $5. Pull up some clips of Randy, the best character. Hulans. Thank you for the 20 Mexicans. You are smart and funny. Get over it. Ahmed. Thank you for the $2. Cartman is totally Pippa. James Spanner. Thank you for $5. Cartman makes the plot happen. Ahmed. Thank you for $2. Pippa get the hose. Dizzy is going wild. Jack Crowding with $5 literally just showed up, and I can already tell Dizzy is one of those South Park fans. Goliath to Heising with $2, I'm falling in love with Dizzy. James Ending with $5, if you need an MRI to compare brain trauma, let me know. Whisper Dragon, thing with $20, I feel like you're getting a slightly skewed and biased opinion of South Park here, Pippa, Lamau, as opposed to an unbiased, objective view of South Park. Hector Gomezing with $10, Dizzy just subscribed to your channel and was wondering if you have membership, couldn't find the join button. I think she has membership enabled. Try refreshing or using a different browser. Make sure you're signed in. Corby! I always struggle to remember what my Kirby game that I played was. My experience with Kirby has been very limited. But then I looked up OST. And I recognized the screen. This is the one I played, chat. This is the one I played, Kirby's Adventure. For some reason, I thought it was like Kirby's Dream Land or something, because when I was describing it to you guys were like, oh, that one. But no, it was Kirby's Adventure. I recognized the home screen. This is the only Kirby game I've ever played. Vita, thank you for coming. Boop, boop, boop. You should stream old Kirby games? You know, it's funny, because I was just thinking about picking up, I was looking into, like, retro... streaming options. Because I wanted to pick up a... Oh, forgot to press play. I wanted to pick up a... Game Boy Advance SP shell. And I wanted to try modding my own. That's difficult. A GBA would be easier to start with. I've never modded one before. So it'd be like beginner project. But there are also some really cool, like, just pre-made ones. But then I was considering there's like I'll still probably try that. That's like a different kind of content. I found this... I opened up Amazon and it's right here. I was tempted to pick up this thing called the RG353V. Because it's like... It looks like a Game Boy. But it has like extra sticks on it. And I guess it can like... It runs on Android. And you can stream stuff very easily from it. And it just seemed cooler than like... booting something up on like a regular emulator, you know? Because a lot of these games, they just don't feel the same if you're not playing them with at least like a similar layout schematic, you know? It's like... You can technically just play them on PC, but it doesn't really feel... It's not as satisfying, I guess, not getting to mash the buttons. I know that's like a really stupid complaint, and realistically, again, I could just like use my PC. I don't know. It just looked cool. RG353V. And then there's something called the Retrone, which I think with the Retrone I can put like actual authentic cartridges into. Which I have. I have quite a few Game Boy Advance games that I'd like to try. That I have the physical cartridge for them, so it'd be fun. And I think the Retrone can do that. But I've seen some complaints about the Retrone. I don't know, this is something I'm literally looking into this like right before stream. Retrones are scary. Jaws grip on the carts. Tactile feedback matters, it does. We've talked about wanting to try the Retrone before. Yeah, now I was like actually looking into it. There are like a bunch of different versions and stuff. I recommend the RG35XX, almost same design, but better. This spot is going to be nuts, eating Mike Tyson's ass on my doors. And Burnick devices are really nice. Switch Joy-Con shell mods are a nightmare. Are they? Are you able to stream from it? I keep forgetting the names. Get a modded PS2, that'd be fun. With the RG353V, yes, I could like... I could set it up to like broadcast to my monitor, and then I could... screen share it. Like, OBS. It. Steam Deck? That's not the same. That's not the same. Like, I can emulate stuff on Steam Deck, but it's like, it's such a different, like, layout. It's just, it's not the same. It's like using an Xbox controller to play a fucking emulated PS2 game. It's just wrong. It's just wrong. Or using an Xbox controller to play an NES game. It's like, yeah, you can technically do it, but it doesn't feel like... It's not the same experience. Like using a Switch for N64 games, yeah. It's better than nothing. It is better than nothing. But like... The idea was to like get something like... fun. To make the experience like more fun for me. And then I'll have more fun streaming. Like retro stuff. And I don't know. I need to look more into retro, because it'd be really nice to be able to accumulate like the physical cartridges. I don't know why I care about physical cartridges, but not... Like, I do care about original hardware. But, like, I feel like... Original cartridges are, like, a nice compromise, right? Because I can't stream from original hardware. I would have to mod it to some extent. I don't know. Random Secret Ritualize, Randy Marsh has... Randy Marsh, the true best character? Lord Thing of Lord Show Pippa, the Ghost Hunter South Park clip? Thing about retro reminds me you haven't done Pokemon in a while. I haven't. Spark of Nothing. For boys, Randy was a geologist, not an astrologist. Randy was literally the lamest type of scientist. Astrologists aren't scientists. Jack Crowling, which was a fake fan. Randy was a geologist, not a meteorologist. Rosa Keen, thank you for the $5. South Park is the kind of show you don't think too much about. Turn on a Pokemon thing. For boys, show Pippa the strong woman competition clip. I've seen that clip. Spider-Dude, thank you for $5. There's a South Park Kenny reference in the official Fate comedy anime. Michael Stout, thank you for the $5. Pippa, you've officially found someone more schizo than you. I'm impressed. Bahamut, thank you for $2. I am become Pitkin, destroyer of mods. Ice Stinger, $2. Pippa, ban incoming. Boomer Wilding, $4. This video has caused Benghazi. Jin Rolls, thank you for the $2. Show the live-action South Park commercial. John Garrison, thank you for $5. Dizzy eating her senpai canceled. Power move. Respect the hustle. Zen Gunman, thank you for the $2. When Dizzy collapsed, no telling what happens. The green thing, my lord. Oh, sure, when Pippa uses the N-word, stream keeps going. When chat uses the N-word, we get silenced. Chat sees how it is. Okay, listen, I've never said the N-word on stream, alright? Dumatai is thinking for $5. Can't wait to see Fishman's reaction to this. Double thinking for $2. Helenol White Shrake did nothing. What? Next Angel thinking for $5. There was an episode where kids went to Afghanistan and met Afghan versions of themselves. Also, Osama bin Laden appears in it. You just did? No, I didn't. On stream. Well, I'm not gonna lie and say I never did. Because, like, when I was younger, right? One of my guildmates... Okay, this is gonna sound really bad. One of my guildmates... was... Let's just say they had the pass. And they were like... Yeah, you should use it too. And then, like... Her boyfriend... would also, like... use it. But he did not have the pass. But, like, he got the pass from her. And... So anyways, the guild I was in, everybody was doing it. But in our defense, we had somebody with the pass who was actively encouraging us! Jin Rollins, Angry Delice. Look up the live-action South Park commercial. Galileo Alonzi Galfrey, thank you for $5. Does she know about Ike's VA? I do not. Graham Singer with the $2. VTech, thank you for $5. Oh, pre-2010, when the world still made sense. Keep digging! How am I digging? It's just what happened. It's just what happened, okay? It's just what happened. Ragnar, thank you for $5. In Canada, there has never been a black guy that has been What? What? CPPC Tech, thank you for the $2. Basically, if you didn't watch SP, you got made fun of. General, thank you for $1. Show Kyle turning into Kylie B fighting Snooki. Could we buy anything for $1? End our suffering? I forgive you, Pippa. Thank you, Arclight. Thank you for your $10 as well. Rib Blood. I'm not gonna lie and be like, oh, I never. What good does that do? Alex Blackfoot, thank you for $5. Kick him. Cole Graham, thank you for the $5. Holy Reddit humor. I'm getting a new tumor. That's a horror thing for $2. Possum jokes sucked, but that wasn't as bad as this guy. Yeah, this was years ago. Benjamin Todd, thank you for the $10. Statler, this comedian. This was back when, like, Bitcoin was, like, worth a lot of money. This was... Oh, I thought they were $10. Oh, I'm not black. Oh, okay. This was, like, her boyfriend, like, did Bitcoin stuff and, like, was teaching people how to do Bitcoin stuff. Like, he was a Bitcoin investor before, like, it was, like, a big thing. And amazing, or otherwise. Nope, I missed it. I'll have to read it later. Damn, that was a long time ago. Well, like, yeah. 2020. No, it wasn't 2020. 10 years ago? It was at least 10 years ago. Benjamin Tottinger, the $10. Statler, this comedian is good for what ails you. Well done for what ails you. Statler and Insomnia, both. Tony Sharping with a $5. Let's get back to the opossum instead of the ginger comedian. Her comedy at least wasn't trash! Let's see, I think you're at $2. Blitz fighting love. Space Guy Rising with $10. Dizzy showed her Scott Tenorman, the band episode. James Jim's ending $5. There's nothing bad about first name, last name. Yes, there is. Adele Lombardo thing on $5. And God, I'm not subscribed to Pippa Pipkin. She sucks. Great thing on BB. You did nothing wrong. Okay. Well, that's the thing with $5. Can you tell Dizzy that she's funnier than you? Also, Pippa Love. Douglas McCarthy thing with the $20. You seem like the type of woman to have a full size candy plush, to be honest. I'm gonna message Dizzy and ask her. Chad wants to know if you have a full-sized Kenny doll. We'll find out. Stay tuned. Malcolm Langney won $5. If you replicate Chupa Claw, the normies will probably buy it like the Lured Hats. Progmy Sterling with the $2. No Fishman. No, Fishman, hey! John Garrison thing with a $2 year-old coffee, yummy! Frederick Moonlight thing with $2, here you go, Dizzy, wait! Rick Bain thing with $5, Jack Crow thing with $5, Pippa, if you still need an idea for Yumicon, just do the Tunnel of Slurs! We'll just bust out a bunch of iPads and we'll duct tape them to the wall and every talent will be in charge of saying a slur. And every the members of Yumicon, they'll just walk through and they'll be like, whoa! Whoa! I didn't realize Face Connect was so multicultural. See anything with the $5? It's easy for Pippa to carry stuff on her back since she doesn't need to carry anything on her chest. Okay, thank you. Malcolm Blank name with $5. Dizzy, I have an idea. Have a jar and accept cash for Super Chat redeeming at Yumicon. Atomizing with $5. How about the episode that was heavy metal movie parody where people were getting high off of cats? What? PTN Feed thing with the $10. Yabcast. Pippa, Lumi, and Dizzy walks into a bar. Jin Roll thing with $2. Play Minorities in My Water Park. What? I like the Spike Man thing with $100! Happy birthday, Pippa. You are 4 years old now. No, I'm not. Everybody loves you. Please brush your teeth. It's not my birthday. I'm not turning 4. And Sandals thing with $5. How about Sir John Rolfe forced Pocahontas into marrying him and made a profit parading their kids around as a traveling freak show? Well, I don't know if that really has to do with Thanksgiving, but that is fucked up. Imagine putting your dick in somebody and then being like, oh my god, our children are so fucked up looking. Wow. I'm gonna put them in a freak show circus. It's like, you put your dick in that. Why are you acting too good for this now? What the fuck? Vasting with $1. Dizzy has massive honkers. Disgust. Yuffling with $2. You should play Mech Warrior 5. You can fight the feds. Dizzy has not responded. Oh my god, part two. Super chat list part two. Oh, it's not that long, okay. Kill my thing with $5. Broke Dizzy, sick in my head. Our strong thing with $10. Pippa's taking our jobs. Everybody back on the pile. Smarty, horny thing with $10. Love the part of this I caught. Did you ever go over the saga of Mr. President? Mr. Garrison? What? Or PC Principal? What? Also, Courtney is confirmed to be a South Park fan. Let that sink in. Courtney is a South Park fan? I feel like that makes sense. Big Bad Beard, thing with $2. I hate Pippa. I want Pippa Sam. Shut up. Papa, thing with $1. We all very well behaved and totally aren't attempting. Oh, okay. El Dorado Eduardo, thing with $2. Sounds like couples counseling work. A Lil's D, thing with $5. If nothing else, you can bully Dizzy for her taste in men. Basic white boys. Literal white boys. Birdie thing with $10. Hey Pippa, just wanted to say I'm over my ex now. Just took a lot of alcohol to do it. Now I'm better. Let's go! Congratulations, Birdie! I'm glad you didn't drink yourself to death. CD thing with $5. Bahamut thing with $5. It's old. I remember it when it first started airing. Oh wow, you're old. I'm a $2. It's called Post Nut Clarity, Pippa. That's fucked up. JP thing with the $2. My face when South Park is altered in my Yoshi. You don't know that! Mr. Euro thing with the $5. Kirby Nightmare and Dreamland for the GBA is a remake of Kirby's Adventure, so people might have been confused. Is it? Oh, so they're the same game. It's just a port? Although, did you guys notice that for some reason, for Game Boy Advance, there were a lot of games where they were like, yo, dude, we're like this game. We're this game. We're this game that already came out for another console. We're that game, but we're handheld now. And then, like, you would pop it in and it would not be that game. It would not be that game at all. In fact, I dare say it would be completely different on every single level, except for perhaps sharing the same IP. Lux ties everything with a $2. 8-bit doll has retro controllers. Now check them out. Well, Roll thing with a $2. W physical game preserver. Mr. Euro thing with $2. The Kirby music really makes this conversation. Wizard Racing with 333. Good club with Dizzy Pippa. Glad you learned some South Park stuff for the game. Also, so glad to hear you haven't given up on the retro thing since you only mentioned it last year in passing. I hope for Pippa rental game day when it happens. Andrew B thing with $2. People be sharing the past like it's Netflix. Mumu Wilding for doors that have been influenced. I just said it. This is your fault. No. Like a stable Sesamini W with 50 HKs. Pippa, I just turned 1/5 of a century old. I don't know if it's a good thing that I was born. Also, tell the cute opossum that I love her and want to marry her and have her half opossum human kids with her. That's bestiality, you weird fuck! Stay away from opossums! Jim's ending for doors. Tap, 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 tap. Plus one. Tap, 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 tap. Okay, then. Alright! Thank you guys so much for stopping by. My name's Pipkin Pippa! That's last name, first name, alright? Last name, first name! And I hope you guys have a wonderful rest of your day! What's up, Cringe? Oh, fuck! Nope, somebody sent another super chat. Hold on, now I gotta see what it was. God damn it. Hold on, let me refresh the page. God damn it. I'll pass this off to thing with 10 pippies. Thank you. Bahamut thing with the... Wait. No. Wait. Didn't somebody just send like a little $2 super chat? Where did it go? It's not appearing in the list. Okay, maybe I'm crazy. Oh, can't act the thing with $2 plus one. Shut up. Alright, let's read. I'm gonna raid into Dizzy's channel. Marksman thing with $2. Hi. Oh my god. I'm gonna raid into Dizzy's channel. Oh, you guys are doing this now. I actually played this thing with the $2. Oh, fuck. What? No. Oh, god damn it. Quayoid, thank you for the $2. Xander, thank you for the $2. Okay. Oh, god damn it. I'll check them. Oh, Tessu, thank you for the $2. Surprise, you didn't. Run 4+ hours again. Also, plus one. Marksman, thank you for the $2. Hi. You motherfuckers. Okay, Dizzy. Dizzy Dokuro! Dizzy Dokuro! Wait, can I not write up? Oh, there she is. Oh, there we go. Oh, God. Castle Puncher, thank you for the $2. Fluffy Mooncat, thank you for the $2. Bombman, thank you for the $2. JP, thank you for the $5. We can keep our hostage, boys. No. Dynamite Doodle, thank you for $2. Keeping you here? No. Xander, thank you for $2. I'll keep around. Don't worry. Oh, my God. Mr. Euro, thank you for the $2. Eddie Lombardo, thank you for the $2. DZ Bikes, thank you for the $2. Account Active, thank you for the $5. As long as I give you money, you don't leave. This is like marriage. No. Dan Chan, thank you for $2. Thank you for sure. Thank you, guys. Okay, I'm in.